And deciding semifinal game between the New York Rangers and the Philadelphia Flyers. Hello, everyone. I'm Tim Ryan. All of the play-by-play of this afternoon's game with me, as usual, our analyst Ted Lindsay, our intermission host Brian McFarland. And Brian, this is where it all ends for one of these teams. The winner will go on to meet the Boston Bruins, starting the final series on Tuesday night. And this series has had everything. It's been a rough, tough series from the very opening game. And we've seen any number of fights. We've had 368 minutes in penalties so far. Some of the chief combatants have been the Rangers' Steve Vickers and Dave Schultz for the Philadelphia Flyers, and several other players have gotten into the act. Injuries have played a role. Hadfield and Kachuk for the New York Rangers. Barry Ashby, this young man here who had such a great season, lost last week with an eye injury in the game here on NBC. And Kelly and Clement also out for the Philadelphia Flyers. The goaltending has been positively brilliant. We've seen Eddie Jockerman turn in some outstanding efforts in goal for the New York Rangers. Bernie Parent of the Philadelphia Flyers with a goals against average of 1.87 in 10 playoff games so far, showing you the same kind of great goaltending he did all season long when he tied for the Vezina Trophy with Chicago's Tony Esposito. And certainly this has been a home ice series, Brian, or we wouldn't be here for a seventh game of Philadelphia.
No question about that, Tim. And I feel that despite what Emil Francis will be telling his players right now, I feel home ice has to give the Flyers a bit of a lift today. It could count for as much as one goal. I'll hear from Ted's comment on that in a moment or two. But before the game, we talked to the rival coaches involved here today, Fred Shiro and Emil Francis, and they had some interesting comment on what kind of strategy we might see here this afternoon. So let's have a listen first to Fred Shiro and then Emil Francis of New York.
I believe for us to win today's game, we have to get back to our normal game. And our normal game is hitting. We've got to hit in every zone as often as we can and as hard as we can. We do that today and we win.
I'll tell you exactly what we're going to have to do to win today. We're going to have to concentrate in two specific areas. One, our skating. Two, our checking, and that means forechecking and backchecking. By concentrating on our forechecking, I feel that we can come up with our 35 to 40 shots on the net. Regardless of how well Bernie Parent is playing or how well they're playing defensively, we know by the law of average, by getting that many shots, we're going to get the goals that we need to win.
Confident words from Emil Francis. Ted Lindsay, what's your opinion on home ice?
I always believe that home ice is an advantage. You have the crowd behind you. They don't play for you, but there's a mental lift there to you. You know the boards just a little bit better. I think it's an advantage. And we have some statistics that I'll give you in a second here of what the advantage is of home ice.
Well, there have been some key performers in addition to the goaltenders in this series. Let's take a look at some of the important matchups here this afternoon. Certainly, Ted, face-offs, which can set the tempo of control of the play, have been terribly important, and these two men have had quite a duel.
Well, possession of the puck in any sport. Here's Pete Stemkowski on your left, has always been a great player in playoffs, has always come up with the big goals. The man on the right, Bobby Clark, both of them recognize the importance of face-offs, and they're about one as many as they've lost in face-offs, which is very important. Then going to the home ice advantage, which we talk about. Rod Gilbert, the New York Rangers, on your left. He's had 15 shots in Madison Square Gardens, only four here at the Spectrum. So that shows you home ice. Then we go to Rick McLeish, who's leading the playoffs, the scorers. On home ice, he's had 17 shots. But in the Gardens, he's only had nine. So definitely home ice does have an advantage for even the goal scorers. We go to defense, a man that won his job back in the Canadian series, Jim Nielsen, a veteran of the Rangers, playing just great defensive hockey, and has continued that in the Philadelphia series, and he'll be playing a lot of defensive hockey today. The man on the right, as you mentioned, Tim, with Ashby out, young Jim Watson, out of junior hockey, has had an awful lot of pressure on him, but he seemed to face that pressure very well. It hasn't broken him yet, and we'll see him performing again this afternoon.
Well, there are some of the key men in this afternoon's seventh and deciding game. As we said earlier, the old cliche, there's no tomorrow for the loser. The winner will move on to meet the Boston Bruins, who have been patiently waiting to start that championship series Tuesday night in Boston. And this crowd in the Spectrum is really ready for this one. Even here in this studio, through the walls, you can hear the sound coming in here. They're really up and ready to go, and certainly that will be a factor, as Ted mentioned earlier, the home crowd, and Brian did too, behind these Philadelphia Flyers. But the Rangers think it doesn't matter where they play, they're ready to come in here and win this game. We'll find out shortly who comes out on top. And this game will be underway in just a moment.
You know, I met a fan coming in here today, and he said, Brian, I'm so excited, I almost had an accident reaching the parking lot. He said, I'm biting my nails. I hope it gets underway soon, and it will be underway in just a moment. McLeish of Philadelphia, leading all playoff scorers at this point, 10 games played. He's scored 10 goals already, has 14 points, along with the veteran Johnny Busick of Boston. He's having a tremendous playoffs. And then Greg Shepherd, the young player for the Boston Bruins, he's been a big plus for the Bruins in the playoffs, 13 points. We look down at Phil Esposito. He always scores well. He's got 11, as do many others, all the way down here to 10. Now, an interesting thing about this game this afternoon is what anthem they're going to play to open proceedings here. You know, when Kate Smith sings God Bless America, the Flyers always seem to win. Their record right here, 34 victories, 3 losses, and 1 tie when Kate Smith lends them a helping hand. So we'll see in just a moment what's going to happen. Here's the PA announcement.
Ladies and gentlemen, will everyone please stand and a salute to the flag as Kate Smith sings God Bless America.
That about says it all for the excitement here at the Spectrum. Kate Smith did indeed sing her thing, and the Flyer fans responded. We'll find out momentarily if the Flyers do. The referee is Art Skoll, the linesmen are John D'Amico and Matt Pavlich. The goaltenders and their goals against averages for these playoffs, 273 and 187. And we're underway. The Flyers in white, the Rangers in blue, Kindrachuk, Schultz, and Selesky for Philadelphia, Stemkowski, Irvin, and Butler for New York. Pete Stemkowski, the first shot of the game is off the leg of Van Imp at the blue line of New York. Schultz takes over the Flyer corner. This is Selesky. A shot, stick save, Jockeman, as Rolf got back to get a piece of him. Schultz ran into Stemkowski, Kindrachuk control. Into the slot, Orest Kindrachuk, a backhander deflected wide. Back to the men centering, it's in the crease. A pileup for it there, and it's held for a faceoff, and referee Art Skoll waving that the play is dead. Selesky getting a good chance down that left side on the feed from Schultz. But Rolf getting back to make the play, and then the close call here.
Here that puck comes right out. Rolf gets it in his feet and wisely drops on it. There is Selesky is in the crease, and Kindrachuk coming in there trying to push it in.
Jockeman had no idea where that was until Rolf finally got it into his leg. Don Selesky scored the opening goal in Game 6 the other night, but the Flyers lost that game in New York. The Rangers have been better off when they've given up the first goal. They've been battling from behind through both of these playoff series. The first goal is supposedly the important goal, especially in the playoffs, but that has not been the case for New York so far. We'll see what develops here this afternoon. I think you can throw all of those statistics out the window when you play the seventh game of the series. Bobby Clark, Simon Ollet, Bill Barber against Rattel, Hatfield, and Gilbert. Clark controls a faceoff. Barber, a high shot off the glass. Rebound, Ollet to the corner, pinned by Seeling, throws it in front. Nielsen steers it to Hatfield. Hatfield playing with a bad ankle. His pass deflected by Clark. Controlled by Joe Watson, who dumps it into the Rangers' zone. Joe Watson and Andre Dupont. The Philadelphia defense, Nielsen and Seeling for New York. Jim Nielsen's pass off the skate of linesman D'Amico. Joe Watson throws it over the Ranger line. Stemkowski off the boards with a puck, but it's Barber of Philadelphia picking it up. Into the Rangers' zone, bumped there with a good check by Nielsen, and the puck cleared into Flyers' territory. Back for it goes Joe Watson. Icing will be called against the New York Rangers. Well, we played just about a minute and a half here in this seventh game of the Stanley Cup semifinal series. And Ted, if there is one position on the ice that could determine the outcome of this game, which do you think it is? Goaltending, defense, or up front?
I would say certainly goaltending. Both teams are going to get their opportunities today, and it'll be the goaltender who can come up with the most great saves, Tim.
Well, they've both been brilliant. Bernie Parent, you're looking at now perhaps a little bit more brilliant only because he's been more severely tested. The Rangers have had more shots. Face-off to the right of Jockeman. Right from the face-off, McLeish went for the net, but he was stopped by Kachuk and Park control. He's met by Dornhofer. There's that Flyer forechecking. And they get another face-off in the Rangers zone. We have Walt Kachuk, number 18. Billy Fairburn, number 10. Steve Vickers, number 8. The forward line for New York for the Flyers. Rick McLeish, the leading playoff goal scorer with 10. Number 19 at center, Ross Lunsbury. Number 18 on the left wing, Gary Dornhofer. Number 12 on the right side. Jim Watson and Ed Van Imp on defense for the Flyers. Brad Park and Dale Roth for New York. Lunsbury shot off the stick to the corner. Kachuk wearing that protective helmet with the face guard because of a broken jaw that he suffered earlier in the playoff action. A long pass from Fairburn, too far for Vickers. Race to the backboard, Van Imp touches it. Icing call against New York.
On that play going into the New York end there, Ed Van Imp took quite a chance. He moved away in deep in that corner, and if the Rangers could have controlled that puck, they'd have had a 2-3-on-1 situation. So, and this is what New York have done in a couple of the last two games, or in the last two games, they started to move in a little bit deeper. So we'll see who will take the most chances this afternoon.
Kachuk against McLeish. Kachuk gets this face-off, back for Brad Park. Park breaks out of his own zone. This is an important part of the New York attack. They've got to have him lugging that puck out for them. One of the very best offensive defensemen in the game. Lonsbury, back of his own goal, dumps along the board for Jimmy Watson. The rookie brings it up the left side. Shoots it into the Rangers' zone, takes a hip check from Park, keeps right on going. Dale Rolfe up the board for Fairburn. McLeish broke that up. Back of the Ranger net, Kachuk hit by Dornhofer, but got the pass to Vickers. Vickers takes a hit from Lonsbury. Vickers' pass picked off by McLeish. He missed the pass to Dornhofer. Park intercepting, brings it up quickly. Drop pass to Kachuk. Slap shot, deflected wide. Park is dumped by Van Imp. Lonsbury back of the net, tied up by Vickers. Lonsbury controlling. Up the boards for Vic McLeish. McLeish checked by Walt Kachuk. Rangers keep it in. Park penalty coming up. Slashing will be the call against the New York Rangers. 17-37 remaining in the first period with a score. Philadelphia nothing. The New York Rangers nothing.
A man advantage, and so far in the power play advantages, they've only scored 5 goals in 31 attempts.
Brad Park for slashing at 2:23. The Flyers 6-5 control the faceoff at their own blue line. Simon Ollet, right side, left side pass for Bill Plett. Plett, number 21, with the beard, rolls it back to the blue line. Barber from the point, late save, rebound, another save on Clark from Eddie Jockeman, and Clark is knocked down by Jimmy Nielsen as Jockeman tucks that puck in. Clark didn't get much on the rebound try. A good shot from Barber at the blue line, and Jockeman made a good save there.
Again, the shot from Barber going right to Jockeman. We see that he makes the save. The rebound comes right back to Clark. Clark gets the wood on it. Pretty good, too, as Jockeman has to make another save. And Clark going in for that rebound as Nielsen comes over.
We're back live. Rod Seeling around for McGregor. McGregor gets it over the blue line. Here's Stemkowski trying to get loose, but an offside pass, or a hand pass for the other on that play. McGregor and Stemkowski are up front. Seeling and Nielsen back to kill off the penalty. Bobby Clark with Bill Flett on left wing here. He's normally a right winger. He's a right-handed shot. Simon Ollet Barber on the point with Tom Bladen, the Flyers power play. Bobby Clark takes over with 1:30 remaining in the penalty to Brad Park. Nolle into the middle for Barber, off the skate, backhander save. Rebound, centered in front, and just off the skate of ceiling, who gets control and shoots it down the ice. Tom Bladen back for it. 1:17 left in the penalty. McLeish is on, replacing Clark. Bladen brings it out, number three, to McLeish. McLeish dumps it into the corner. Jockerman comes out of there. He likes to come out and control that puck. Takes a check from Nolle. Good clean check. Then Jockerman bumps in. Flyers keep it in. Bladen, a deflection wide. McLeish centers it into the slot. Lonsberry whirling. Lonsberry shoots and a save by Jockerman. Rebound to Bladen. Another drive. That's wide. All the way to the blue line. On the near board, Barber and McGregor collide. In the corner, Lonsberry with ceiling. Puck taken by McLeish. The whistle blows.
Penalty on Barber, I believe, here. He laid that lumber on McGregor. And, of course, Skov, recognizing that this game is an important one and might get out of control, is going to call everything very, very quickly here to Barber. Still over at McGregor. McGregor probably did something to irritate Bill a little bit, but that will be expected here this afternoon. You try to get that man off the ice if you can.
Barber for slashing at 3:41. Watch Eddie Jockerman at work here.
Jockerman very, very busy as Philadelphia had a couple of good opportunities. There's Barber again, and he'll see him backhand that pass out here.
Good save on him by Jockerman on the backhand try, and then he threw it into the slot, but it went off-ceiling skate out of trouble. 42 seconds left in the penalty to Park. The teams will play five aside for that length of time, and then the Rangers will have the man advantage. The teams need only three more minutes now to break the all-time playoff record for combined penalty minutes in a series. They've already had 368. They needed only seven more to break that record, and now they need only three more minutes. Joe Watson up the boards, intended for Kindrychuk. It goes deep into the Ranger zone. Kindrychuk and Selesky up front against Kachuk and Fairburn for New York. Dale Rolfe to Fairburn, number 10, down the right side. Fairburn fakes a shot over the line. Centers it for Kachuk, and he deflected it on the goal. Perron had to be alert. Good play by Kachuk. On the deflection try. Kindrychuk back quickly, trying to split the defense. Breaks through, has the puck in the corner. Throws it for Selesky. Shoots. Deflection, and Jockerman made the save. As he was screened by Ceiling, who tried to block the shot, it came through, and Jockerman saw it at the last instant. And there he is talking to Rod Ceiling.
Good play by Kindrychuk, who went through the center. Here's the save on Selesky. Wasn't a real hard shot, but those are usually the ones that dribble through. The New York Rangers will have a man advantage here very shortly, and of course Emil Francis hasn't been too happy with his power play, which led the league this year.
5 seconds left in the penalty to Park. Face off to the left of Jockerman, and Rattel against Clark. Rattel and Gilbert against Clark and Crisp up front. And Crisp takes it back because that penalty is expiring to Park. Now Rangers have the extra man on the ice. It's shot down the ice by Jimmy Watson. New York playing 6 men against 5 with 1:10 left in the penalty to Bill Barber. Park controlling the power play. Up the middle to Rattel. John Rattel with Gilbert and Hatfield, the forward line. This is Gilbert. Gilbert checked in the corner by Jim Watson. Gets it back to Park. Park to Rattel. Good pass in there. Rattel getting control of Gilbert. Back to the blue line, Park. Park having difficulty at the blue line, is checked by Crisp. Park has to go back, and that gets an appreciative burst of applause from the partisan Spectrum fans. Rolfe to Hatfield. Good work by Terry Crisp on Park. Gilbert, low sinking slap shot caught by Perron. Has got that quick left hand. Park checking Hatfield, and the puck shot down the ice. The race for it, Park and Crisp. Park cuts him off the Ranger blue line. 26 seconds left in the penalty to Philadelphia's Barber. Hatfield, left side feed to Rattel. Rattel, a slap shot deflected high off the glass. Lonsberry takes it, slaps it down the ice. 17 seconds left in Barber's penalty. Jockerman holds it up for Nielsen. Teams changing on the fly. McGregor and Stemkowski now on for New York. Here's McGregor, number 12 of the helmet. Met there by Dornhofer. Shoots it over the line off the board. Stemkowski to McGregor. Can't get the shot away. Has it off the backboard. Back out to the blue line. Hatfield. Hatfield lost control. Barber out of the penalty box. Took it away to Dornhofer. Dornhofer checks. Here's Lonsbury's shot wide. Guckman comes out to knock it away from Dornhofer. Hatfield has it. Up the middle, too far for McGregor. Dupont has it for Philadelphia. Waiting for Lonsbury to get onside. Takes it to the near board. Pinned by McGregor. And it's held for a faceoff with 14:01 remaining in the first period. The score of the New York Rangers, nothing. The Philadelphia Flyers, nothing. Chuck Schultz and Zaleski against Kachuk, Fairburn, and Steve Vickers. And remember, Fred Sherrill will have that final line change. Kindrachuk gives Jockerman a bump. That's been a predominant part of this series. Jockerman out there controlling the puck, and Flyers running into him. Joe Watson back in his own zone. Icing call against the New York Rangers again. As they've been trying for long passes, Ted, that haven't been clicking, and they've had three icings called as they've tried to get a man in loose.
Well, at Philadelphia, as I mentioned, they move that defense up, and New York are just leaving that man up towards center ice, hoping that they can get that one break. I feel that if the pressure that Philadelphia have had on so far in this game, and which as many times it happens, if the visiting club can survive that first period of the onslaught, generally, the advantage goes to them just a little bit, because a lot of times the club has given everything they had for that one goal in that first period at home.
Rangers control this faceoff. Rod Sealing with McLeish right on him. Gets out of his own zone. Feeds it up to Walt Kachuk. Long slap shot sinking. Grabbed by Perron. Perron gives it off to Dupont. Dupont intended for Dornhofer, but Nielsen keeps it in. Ran into the referee, Skov. Skov hurt his leg on the play. Nielsen's shot comes to Fairburn on a deflection. He's hand on a shot, and then it's blocked by Dupont. As Kachuk had the chance, Dupont stopped it. McLeish feeds Dornhofer to McLeish. Over the line, fakes a shot. McLeish turns it on a shot. Right on, and a late save by Jockerman. Gets his own rebound. McLeish, who's been sensational here in Philadelphia, tried the deflection attempt at Dornhofer, and he missed it. Puck knocked out the center ice, and Jockerman gave Dornhofer a shot. And there's going to be penalties here. Fairburn and McLeish are both going as Art Skov cracking down on the rough stuff here early. And McLeish and Fairburn will both get the gate.
Philadelphia were very lucky on that opportunity by Fairburn that he missed the puck because he was right in there, and Perron was dragging that leg, the right leg, and stopped that soft shot.
Time of the penalty, 7 minutes, 1 second.
We'll watch Dornhofer, number 12, move in, and he plays a lot in that crease. You'll see him right back into Jockerman here, and then Jockerman gives him the shove out of there. Dornhofer is great for getting around those creases.
McLeish and Fairburn go for elbowing at 7:01. The teams will play five aside for the next 2 minutes. Terry Crisp, checked by Rattel. Park takes over. Park breaks in quickly, feeds Rattel. Rattel shoots, glove save, Perron, and he holds on for a faceoff in Philadelphia territory.
That penalty certainly gives New York the advantage because McLeish is the leading point getter in the playoffs. Fairburn is a great defensive player, so you have to get goals to win. So McLeish is going to have to keep himself on the ice today.
McLeish had been buzzing around here in the early going. That last shift particularly, he was dangerous. Made a good move. Got a shot, his own rebound, and made another play before they finally stopped him. Watson breaks out. Watson to Flett on the right side. Can't get around Dale Raul. Park back for it. Park. Swings away from Flett. Flett and Crisp against Rattel and Gilbert, the forward matchups. Park giving to Dale Rolfe. Rolfe, a good skating defenseman as well. Brings it up over center ice. Throws a flip shot in. Perron played it carefully. Rebound Rattel. And Perron had to make the save in the short side. Dupont to Flett. Flett for Crisp. But Crisp was coming in toward Flett. And the pass went right between his legs. Park gives it to Gilbert. Gilbert back to Park. Good pass with Flett coming off the puck. Park a drive blocked by Joe Watson. Rebounds to Flett, checked by Gilbert. And Park is dumped in there. Pardon me, Rattel is dumped by Jimmy Watson. Park controlling inside the blue line of Rolfe. Rolfe flips it in for Gilbert. A backhand golf try hit the side of the net. Flett trying to break out. Bill Flett has had only 6 shots on net in this series. Long shot wide. Bobby Clark gets a rebound off the corner boards. Park takes him out of the play. Gilbert gets a bump. And if the drive, caught by Jockerman, as Clark got that pass over there anyway. Rolfe flips it ahead for Rattel too far. Jimmy Watson swings back at his own blue line. Jimmy Watson shoots it into the Ranger zone. Jockerman comes out to cut it off. 24 seconds left in the twin penalties to McLeish and Fairburn. Dale Rolfe organizing the New York attack. Out for Stemkowski, is on with McGregor now against Barber and Clark. McGregor trying to get loose. Barber with him all the way. Takes him into the corner, gives him a high elbow. There'll be a penalty here as holding is called, and referee Art Scove on top of that one all the way. Could have called it holding or elbowing, and it's a holding call against Bill Barber, his second penalty of the game.
McGregor is having the advantage, as I mentioned, over Barber. They had that little altercation. Here is the holding on him as he put the left arm on him, taking him into the corner. And McGregor got his goat a little bit in that first, in the early part of the period here. And Bill, still a little incensed over it, has got himself another, what could be a costly penalty.
Barber for holding at 8:52. There are 9 seconds remaining in the twin penalties to McLeish and Fairburn. And we've now shattered the record of 375 penalty minutes by both teams in one series. Boston and New York set that in 1970 in the quarterfinal round. The Flyers and the Rangers have gone by. Flyers had already set the record for most penalties by one team in a series. The most penalty minutes, 237, breaking Boston's record. So, as we said earlier, this has been a rough, tough one all the way. Clark takes it right away from Stemkowski on the faceoff. One man back is Nielsen. Takes a shot cut by Jockerman. And Jockerman throws it back of his goal for Bobby Russo. And back on the ice are McLeish and Fairburn. Rangers, 6-5. Now 1:44 left in the penalty to Barber. Bobby Russo over the line offside is called as Van Imp ran into Russo. Russo slowing up at the line through Ted Irvin offside on the left wing.
Russo controlling the puck, and you just see the cross check here by Van Emp, knocking Russo down. And as he made that little deke, it was just enough to throw his left winger offside.
Scoreless hockey here with 10:48 to go in the first period. 1:40 left in the penalty to Barber. Game 7 of the Stanley Cup semifinal series. The winner to meet the Boston Bruins in the championship round starting Tuesday night in Boston. Bobby Russo flips it into the Philadelphia zone. Van Emp back. Van Imp off the boards for Clark, couldn't get it. Park keeps it in with a shot wide. Gilbert off the boards. A slap shot caught by Perron. Perron shoots it up but not out. Good play by Park, anticipating. Keeps it in. Gilbert checked by Lonsbury. Lonsbury breaks out. Bobby Russo back. One-on-one. Fakes the shot. Inside, Park is on it now. The inside move gave Park a chance to get back and make the check. Hatfield comes out. Fans want a penalty on Park, but none forthcoming. 1:05 left in Barber's penalty. Park over the line. He's really been active for New York in this first period. Joe Watson stops him. He's McLeish. Rick McLeish, one man back, Russo. McLeish trying to get through, and Jockerman pokes it away. As he tried to slip it through Bobby Russo, Jockerman got that goal stick on it. Gilbert to Hatfield. Rangers quickly back. Slap shot wide. Rebound off the side for Dornhofer. Hits it by Russo. Here's McLeish again. Dornhofer with him. McLeish in. He shoots right on, and Jockerman took the angle away to make the save. 37 seconds left in the holding penalty to Barber, and the fans give McLeish a big hand. He's been all over the ice for the Flyers in this first 10 minutes of play.
As I mentioned about McLeish having to stay in out of the penalty box to show how valuable he is offensively, here the Philadelphia are a man short, and he's given the Rangers problems twice. Here Jockerman makes that save on McLeish as Dornhofer comes in looking for the rebound. And in the last 15 manpower advantages, the Rangers have not scored against Philadelphia. They've only scored four times in 45 manpower advantages.
Bobby Clark took the faceoff away from Kachuk, but the Rangers control it anyway, and Kachuk brings it out. He's bumped at the blue line by Joe Watson. Back comes DuPont. DuPont, the crowd calling Moose, 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 his nickname. Backhander caught by Jockerman. Then knocks it away from Dornhofer, who wanted to start the play out and got away with it. Fairburn, 3-on-2. Fairburn to Kachuk in the slot. Just wide as Fairburn got the backhander trying for the wide side. And he had it past Perron, but wide of the net. Rangers keep it in. DuPont shooting to the blue line. Sealing keeping it in. Sealing to Kachuk. Kachuk on his backhand off the board for Sealing. Sealing a high rising shot. Cut by Perron. Knocked down and held. And Joe Watson had Vickers pinned against that goalpost as he was camped there. 9 minutes left in the first period. The score of the New York Rangers nothing. The Philadelphia Flyers nothing. Nielsen shot caught by Bernie Perron from the blue line, and the Flyers bring it out. Schultz intended for Kinderchuk too far. On the corner boards, Nielsen out for Hatfield, steers it right to Schultz of Philadelphia, checked by Rattel. Van Imp to Schultz. Schultz bumped by Hatfield and offside of Selesky. inside the blue line. Let's see that action back in the Philadelphia zone, Ted.
There's Watson getting Vickers, making sure he doesn't get in on that rebound that Perron juggled, and then comes out here as he juggles it, drops it, he quickly smothers it, but Joe Watson was making sure that Vickers wasn't going to have an opportunity to deflect it.
I'd say he had him pretty well pinned up there. He used the goalpost as another man. Rattel controlling, shoots it into the Flyer zone. 8:34 to go, scoreless hockey first period. Kindrachuk breaks out. He has Selesky and Schultz with him. Here's Schultz on the left wing. Trying to get around, Park can't do it. Back of the goal, still has a puck. His pass off the leg, Selesky didn't see it as it rebounded to him. Has it now to Schultz, trying to get it to Kindrachuk, blocked by Rolf. Van Imp keeps it in, pressure by the Flyers now. Park, in his own zone, sidesteps a hit from Schultz. Checked by Kindrachuk. Kindrachuk steals, shoots, save, Dockerman. And he, Rolf gives Kindrachuk a little shot, who pushes Park, up come the sticks. And here's Schultz and Rolf. Schultz got the gloves off and landed one on Rolf before he got set. Rolf and Dave Schultz, the main event here. Schultz lands two or three punches. Rolf trying to pin him against the glass. They're all alone as the linesmen have everybody else separated. Now Schultz has a grip on Rolf's hair. Schultz still throwing punches, and Dale Rolf getting the worst of this as he tries to hold on. And Schultz landed several there before Matt Pavlich finally got in between them. Now John D'Amico, the other linesman, has Schultz pinned against the crossbar, and a partisan Philadelphia fans love that action by Dave Schultz, and will certainly have major penalties here. And Dave Schultz wins another main event here at the Spectrum. It's not hockey, mind you, but the fans love it anyway.
There's no doubt about who won that one. That right arm of Schultz was just landing and landing and landing. As he had a hold of Rolf with his left arm and just kept him within range. And Rolf was too busy defending himself without getting too much on the offense.
8:05 remaining in this first period with the score of the New York Rangers nothing, the Philadelphia Flyers nothing.
Started all this was a fine play by Kindrachuk, and Schultz took offense to the fact that Rolf gave his center man a little bit of a rough go here as Kindrachuk really tests Jockerman here. Now you'll see him go in on the rebound, and that's where he hit him with the left and the up high, and then you see Schultz come in here very quickly.
Back to you, Tim. Terry Crisp controls a faceoff, a backhander by Cowick, the rookie out there, goes to Crisp. Crisp shoots it back to the New York goal. Blayton checked by Irvin. Nielsen back of the goal. Crisp gives him a bump, and Nielsen comes out with a puck. Stemkowski has it. Teams playing six aside. Coincidental major penalties to Rolf and Schultz at 11:55, so there is no manpower disadvantage out on the ice. Stemkowski tried to shoot it into the Flyers' zone. It deflected over the glass and out of play. And we see for the first time Bruce Cowick, number 27. There's Dave Schultz in the penalty box. And Rolf, off for repairs, is not in the Rangers side of that penalty bench, as he took a few shots and required some attention. Bruce Cowick from Victoria, British Columbia, acquired in a minor league deal with the San Diego team of the Western Hockey League. Philadelphia traded four minor leaguers for Cowick, and he played this year for Richmond, the Flyers farm club in the American Hockey League, and was brought up during the playoffs because of the injuries to Flyers regulars. And he played his first game the other night in New York and acquitted himself very well, although he was covering Ron Harris when Harris got what proved to be the winning goal. But Harris and Cowick, two strong young men, Harris got the shot away anyway. Cowick was doing his job, but Harris got the shot away. Nielsen pokes it away from Plett. DuPont tried to keep it in, but it came over the blue line, and thus the offside call. Bill Plett caught inside the blue line.
Yes. Bob Seeling was very fortunate there as he passed that puck out into the center in front of his net, which is always dangerous unless you're about 200% sure it's going to get there. Philadelphia player has anticipated and moved in there very quickly. Man that's played a lot of hockey for this club and really responsible for why they are here along with Jockerman. Scored the winning goal against Montreal in a sudden death overtime, and got a big goal in New York the other night against Philadelphia.
Terry Crisp here, as we look at this replay, doing his usual digging work against Jim Nielsen. Nielsen lucky to get out of there as Crisp showing that strong Flyers forechecking. That's their game. We're back live in Brad Park, controlling out of his own zone. Marat on them for the first time for New York on defense number six. Van Imp touches the puck. Icing call again against the New York Rangers. For New York, Stemkowski, Urban, and Fairburn. A mixed bag out there for the Rangers. And for the Flyers, McLeish, Dornhofer, and Lonsbury, a regular unit for Philadelphia. Now Kachuk and Vickers come out to join Fairburn, completing that line.
Dave Schultz there in our picture. Records are made to be broken. And he's broken one, of course, in the penalties. He has 101 minutes in 11 games, and he broke the record of John Ferguson. It was set in 1969. John Ferguson had 80 minutes.
John Ferguson, a great Montreal Canadiens star, who no doubt is watching up there in Montreal today, this Stanley Cup playoff action. Brad Park out for Vickers. Vickers over the center red line, fakes a shot, met there by Jimmy Watson, and Van Impe takes over. He hit the referee. Skova's been hit twice today. He's having himself a rough afternoon. Kachuk, a shot deflected wide. Van Impe up the boards intended for Dornhofer. Kachuk anticipating, they're ahead of him. Dornhofer keeps digging, so does Kachuk. Got it to Vickers, to Fairburn, a slap shot wide. Rebound all the way to the blue line. Marat fires it off the boards around back of the goal. Vickers controlling. Vickers met by Jim Watson. Goes to the corner again, trying to center to Kachuk. Kachuk to the blue line in the slot. Park. Good pass. Fairburn backhander. Score! Billy Fairburn. And Perron claiming that he was interfered with by Walt Kachuk. But I don't think there'll be any call on it. Fairburn scored the backhander, and New York leads it 1-0.
Well, New York gets first blood here as Van Impe goes down. Park makes a good play here. Fakes the shot, then gets it into Fairburn. And you see Kachuk come over and hit Perron, but it was after the puck was in. And he wasn't in the crease, so Skov was right on the job.
No question about it. The puck was here, already in before Kachuk arrived. Yeah.
Here's the fake by Park, who made a good play, went between his legs, and then he was knocked down.
Fairburn opens the scoring in their seventh game of the Stanley Cup semifinal. Park and Kachuk assisting. Marat shoots it in off Joe Watson in the Flyer zone. Kachuk dumps it to the corner. Vickers after it, well covered by Joe Watson. Lonsbury dumped there by Kachuk. There'll be a penalty to Walt Kachuk, who really stepped into Lonsbury and I believe got that elbow up a little high. It'll be an elbow or a high stick against Walt Kachuk. And the Flyers will have a power play chance. Elbowing is the call.
He stepped right into him. You see the elbow go up here as he got him. I think it was more the arm than it was the elbow, more around the wrist part. But he really put him down as Kachuk is an exceptionally strong forward.
13:43, the time of the goal. Fairburn from Kachuk and Park. Fairburn's third Stanley Cup goal this season. The penalty to Kachuk, elbowing at 14:05. Flyers with a man advantage, 6-5. Fred Sherrill, their coach, sends out Bobby Clark, Gary Dornhofer, Rick McLeish on the left wing, Bladen and Barber on the blue line. Stemkowski, McGregor, Nielsen, and Sealing the penalty killers. Flyers control that faceoff. Stemkowski and Clark continue their duel as controlling that puck. Clark flips it in. Dornhofer goes to the corner. Gary Dornhofer checked by Nielsen. Stemkowski comes in to help. Dornhofer knocks it away. Stemkowski has it now. Up the boards for McGregor. Barber beats him. McGregor checking him, but the Flyers keep it in Sealing. Gets control for New York in the corner. Around the boards for Stemkowski. Too far. Blade gambled. Came up. Kept it into McLeish. Good check on him by Nielsen. Barber with it. Barber throws it toward the goal. Jockman put it on. Score! McLeish from Bobby Clark. As Bobby Clark battles Jockman for that loose puck and got it over to McLeish, who was all alone, and fired it into the empty net. 1-1 the score.
The rebound came right back to Clark, and Jockman moved out to cover the angle here. And then he puts it right over to McLeish, who just puts it into the open net. We have a 1-1 hockey game here in the first. McLeish, again, the leading scorer. Here it is. The save, then the pass, right over to McLeish. That's McLeish's 11th goal here in the playoffs. There it is again. Those are the kind a hockey player likes to get when that goaltender's out.
You know, Bobby Clark has not been much of a force in the scoring department in the playoffs, but he's made an awful lot of big plays in addition to all of his usual penalty killing and power play work, and he got the assist there as he hung in there against Jockman on the doorstep, took a check and got the puck over to McLeish, and it's a 1-1 hockey game. Team's back at full strength as the penalty to Kachukic fires with a goal. Stemkowski shoots it in. Joe Watson in the corner, bumped by Irvin. Got the pass to Nolet, who got away from Stemkowski. Feeds Clark to DuPont. DuPont shoots it into the Rangers' zone. Out comes Jochen on Nolet. Nolet trying to control a puck to Clark. He did. Jochen back on the net. Shot by Joe Watson. Blocked. Stemkowski trying to break loose. Watson got a piece of him, and Clark got the puck to DuPont. DuPont shoots it in. Jochman pokes it away from Nolet. Marat shoots it away from Nolet. Marat with Barber on him, handed it right to Kindrachuk, but Marat recovers and dumps to center ice. Stemkowski stopped by DuPont. Nolet back. He's checked by Park. Nolet again off the board for Kindrachuk. Kindrachuk to Nolet in the corner. Nolet back to the goal, trying to find a man in front, takes a hit from Marat, took a swing at him. There'll be a penalty to Nolet for slashing at Marat. And as the Rangers finally are held in there by Flett, they get the whistle and a penalty to Simon Nolet. 4:21 to go in the first period with a score. The New York Rangers won, the Philadelphia Flyers won. Dale Rolfe on the left of your screen is now in the penalty box after having some repairs from his fight with Schultz. And you see Simon Nolet has joined Dave Schultz in the penalty box for the Flyers, slashing at 15:39 as he took a clean check from Marat and responded with a slash up high that fortunately missed. But he was called for it. Art Scove right on top of the play. Rangers 6 men against 5. Gilbert shoots it off the stick of Jim Watson, who turns and shoots it out. Russo on the point with Park. Rattel, Hatfield, and Gilbert. The forward lines for New York. The pass intended for Hatfield, broken up by Barber. Clark trying to break loose. Russo knocks it down. Clark overskates it. Gilbert picks it up. Gilbert to Hatfield. At center ice. Rink wide to Russo. Russo over the blue line. Stick handling. Trying to get it through to Gilbert. Went off the stick to Clark. Gilbert took a stiff check from Van Imp and cross-checked him. Scholes didn't see that. Gilbert lost the stick. Clark has the puck. Bobby Clark comes out. Has Barber ahead of him. The pass to Barber. The breakaway. Control the puck, it went wide. Barber has it now, throwing it back to the blue line. Off the boards, Watson can't get up, but Chris does and shoots it in offside. Barber caught inside the Ranger line. Close call there for New York as Clark sent Barber in. 1:01 to go on the penalty to Nolet. There is Jean Rattel, one of the great players in the National Hockey League. Has not been terribly effective in postseason play, but in a game like this, he's the kind of player who can come up with a big play.
There, Barber. Bill Barber just lost control of that puck as Jochiman came out and hurried him just a little bit. It was a good move on Jochiman's part as it made him hurry.
Back live, Flyers control. 57 seconds left in the penalty. DuPont for Bill Flett. Nielsen cuts him off, gives him a ride into the end boards. Flett still battling for that puck. Kachuk comes back to help out Nielsen. Kachuk feeds Fairburn. Kachuk, Fairburn, and Vickers, the forward line for New York. Flett and Chris, the penalty killers. Flett intercepts and flips to the New York line. Ceiling to Kachuk. Sidesteps a hit from Flett, but lost control of the puck. Joe Watson shoots it in. The Flyers have been very effective penalty killers in this series. This has been a major weakness of the Rangers on the power play, and they led the league in power play goals over the regular season. Ceiling comes out. Ceiling away from Chris. Shot it into the Flyers zone, but Dornhofer shoots it down the ice. 15 seconds left in the slashing penalty to Nolet. The Rangers sitting out Jack Egers today as Hatfield is back in action. Matisse breaks up that play and stick handles into the Rangers zone with 3 seconds left in the penalty. Now back to DuPont. DuPont controlling Nolet out of the penalty box. Team's back at full strength. DuPont brings it in. DuPont throws it into the slot. Too far for everybody. Dornhofer up to Matisse. Shot. Finally gets it. Nolet still has it. Throws it in. Poked by McLeish. Cleared out of there by Ceiling. Back at the Philadelphia line, Jimmy Watson has it. Tremendous Stanley Cup playoff action here at the Spectrum. Game 7. There's no tomorrow for the loser. Lonsberry trying to get control of the puck. Went off the stick to the corner. Park and Lonsberry go there for it. Park pinned Lonsberry and the puck picked up by Stemkowski. 1:44 left in the period. Stemkowski to Gilles Marat. Over the line. Team's changing on the move. The return pass to Stemkowski, checked by Jim Watson. Stemkowski threw it back of the Flyer goal. Ed Van Imp to Lonsberry. Ross Lonsberry checked by Bruce McGregor. McLeish takes over. Rick McLeish checked by Stemkowski. There'll be a penalty to Stemkowski of New York for dumping Rick McLeish. And a whistle blows. McLeish hasn't heard it yet. Penalty to Pete Stemkowski for tripping. The majors to Schultz and Rolfe have expired. And they come on as the whistle blows. Philadelphia will have the man advantage for the remaining 1:23 of this period.
Here's the penalty on McLeish, as you'll see. Stemkowski taking the feed here right out from under him. Shots in the first period so far, 17 for Philadelphia, 9 for New York, and that's just about, there it is again, as he really takes a belly flopper. And that's just about indicates the play, although, as I said earlier, if New York can get out of this first period even or even ahead, they'll be very, very happy, expecting that pressure in the first period from Philadelphia here today.
Bobby Clark, Rick McLeish, Bladen, Barber, and Gornhofer will be the power play. Rattel, McGregor, Rolfe, and Park, the penalty killers. Some debris on the ice down in the flyer zone. Bernie Perron doing a little housekeeping. And Matt Pavlich will go back there to help him clean it up. Back of the flyer goal. And we have 1:23 remaining in this first period. Flyers will play that with the extra man and then finish off the penalty at the beginning of period two. Remember, in Stanley Cup hockey, if the teams are tied at the end of regulation time, we'll have overtime. The Rangers have won the only overtime game in this series so far. The goal by Rod Gilbert last Sunday here on NBC, 2-1. Clark got the faceoff, but he was checked by McGregor, and then Rattel dropped it back to Rolfe, flipped it into the Flyer zone. Barber to Clark, 1:15 left in the period. Bobby Clark with McLeish down the left side. Park after him, forcing him to the corner. Park takes him out of the play, battle for the puck, and it's held long enough for a faceoff in the Rangers' zone. 1:06 left.
Excuse me, Tim. Park, you know, of course, he's one of the best, and he has certainly played just fabulous hockey for the Rangers throughout the playoffs.
Bobby Clark showing you a toothless smile there. Well, maybe not a smile. Clark to McLeish, back to Barber. A drive deflected by Dornhofer wide. McGregor got the rebound and got it over the blue line. 1:35 left in the penalty, 55 seconds left in the period. Dornhofer to Barber. Barber around McGregor, but McGregor comes up with a puck. Can't get it out. McLeish keeps it in. Bobby Clark comes up, a shot wide. Rolfe goes to the sideboards, finds an opening, and shoots it down the ice off the stick of Jean Rattel. 38 seconds left. 1-1 the score. Clark slowly out of his own zone. All the Flyers up. A flip shot off the corner boards. Barber after it. Jockeman shoots it off the glass. McLeish to the blue line for Clark. Clark back for McLeish. McLeish centers it to Barber, and Rattel did a good check on him. Here's Bladen. Bladen stick handling. Check by Clark, but the shot away anyway, and Jockeman made the save through the traffic. Good play by Bladen and a good save by Jockeman. Barber had the chance, but he didn't pull the trigger before Rattel made the good check on him from behind.
Bill Barber, who's right here, has it, and he just, Rolfe,
Rattel made the check on him.
I'm sorry. Thought it was Rolfe, but Barber didn't get that puck away quick enough. Here it is, but Rattel came back and took him right out of the play. Good defensive play by Rattel. That's twice that Barber has had good opportunities. Once on the breakaway where he lost the puck, and again here he couldn't get the shot away. He couldn't get his handle on it.
And Jockeman stopped Bladen on the follow-up play. We're back live, and it's knocked out over the blue line by Dale Rolfe. Back to the Flyer zone. 10 seconds left in the period. Watson to Clark to McLeish, trying to get away from Park. McLeish goes to the corner. Throws it back to the goal. Dale Rolfe gives him a bump, and DuPont gets the puck as the buzzer sounds, ending this first period of play. Tremendous Stanley Cup playoff action from the Spectrum in Philadelphia, with the score at the end of 1. The New York Rangers won. The Philadelphia Flyers won.
Of course, you have to get the opportunities also, and talking about McLeish offensively, he's had 31 shots on goal in this series, and there's Pete Stemkowski in the penalty box, and the Rangers will start this second period a man short.
37 seconds left. And the penalty to Stemkowski, the tripping call at 18:37. The Flyer power play, Bobby Clark at center, Rick McLeish on the left wing, Gary Dornhofer on the right side, Bladen and DuPont. The penalty killers for New York on our right, Kachuk with Fairburn, Rolfe and Park. This foursome, one of the best penalty killing units in hockey. Rangers control, and Dale Rolfe has the puck and shoots it in. Rolfe has a little bandage there on his forehead as a result of that altercation with Dave Schultz. DuPont brings it up. All the Flyers come up. Everybody with Bladen trailing. 4 Flyers up. The shot in off the stick of Kachuk. Dornhofer after it. Jockeman beat him to it, threw it back of his goal for Fairburn. Checked from behind by McLeish. Park follows on and has control. Stick handling now. Gets away from McLeish. Right side pass for Fairburn. Off the boards, DuPont catches him. He comes in with the puck anyway. Throws it in the slot. Dornhofer took it away as Park was dumped by Bobby Clark. Park looked at referee Art Scholl for a penalty, but none came. Dornhofer dropped to McLeish. High drive wide. Layton on the rebound. And Dornhofer checked by Dale Rolfe, and Rolfe has control. Ahead for Stemkowski out of the penalty box. One-on-one against DuPont. Drop pass, Fairburn. Checked by Chris. DuPont clears it out down into the Ranger zone. As the teams are back at full strength, icing will be called against the Flyers.
With that penalty up, and of course the Philadelphia club being at the opposite end of their bench, DuPont wanting to get fresh members of his team on that ice, wisely iced it to give Fred Sherrill a chance to get fresh men and new defense and new forwards on there.
Face off to the left of Bernie Perron, Rattel, Hatfield, Gilbert against Chris, Flett, and Barber. Chris playing in Clark's spot, Clark having just completed that power play for Philadelphia. Chris gets the faceoff back to Jim Watson. Around the boards for bearded Bill Flett. Flett away from Hatfield to feed to Chris. Chris steered it in through the legs of Nielsen. Nielsen racing back for it. Gets it to Hatfield. Chris in there forechecking. Back of the goal. Barber is there in front for Flett. That just missed. Jimmy Watson a drive wide. Rebound off the backboards. Flett. Checked by Hatfield. Barber. As the Flyers apply more pressure. Flett. All the way to the blue line. Too far for Jimmy Watson. The pass was too hard and too far ahead of him. Back in the Flyers' zone. Van Imp. In the middle of Chris. Good pass there. Quickly to Flett over the line. Flett's left shot. Cut by Jockeman. He saw that one all the way. Jockeman clears it out to center ice. Van Imp feeds Terry Crisp. Coming out of the Ranger zone. Crisp. Cross ice pass. Jimmy Watson shoots and hits a leg, and offside is called at the New York blue line.
These coaches are changing these lines very, very quickly. But again, as I say, just to keep fresh men on the ice, there's no tomorrow for one of these clubs. There's Fred Sherrill, and of course, Emil Francis, and has done a tremendous job with the New York Rangers club when he took over partway through the season. Got them right on the track and has brought them this far.
Ron Harris is out on right wing. Stemkowski and Irvin, the Flyers can't be too happy to see Harris out there. Not only does he hit people, but he scored that winning goal Thursday night. Stemkowski to Brad Park. Park over to Rolfe. Team's playing at six aside. Dale Rolfe throws it off the corner board. Stemkowski tried to center. Checked by DuPont. Lost his balance. Hindrichuk gets control, beating Selesky. Hindrichuk, Selesky, and Schultz. The line for Philadelphia. Selesky, number 11, down the right side. Rolfe bumps into the corner. Center, he can. Oh, what a save by Brad Park. It's still loose. Score. Hindrichuk. Horace Hindrichuk. Brings Philadelphia in front. 2-1. And Jockeman was down helplessly. The puck right on the goal line. Brad Park scooped it out. But Philadelphia stayed on it and scored the go-ahead goal.
Here's the play. Schultz getting a good shot away. There it is. Not quite over the line. And Park made a good play, clearing it out of here as he got it. But he lost possession of the puck. And there's Kinderchuk getting his shot. Comes back to him. And then he puts the rebound. And it hit Harris on the hand and went in.
Harris nearly stopped the second try after Park had stopped the first one.
Here's the rush going in again. Selesky going around the outside of Rolfe. Getting that puck, and there's the shot by Schultz. Comes back to Kinderchuk, and on the backhand, and Harris almost stopped it, as you saw there, where it hit him in the hand.
2-1, Philadelphia in front. And Selesky made a great pass out there with Rolfe all over him to start that play. The pass to Schultz, and he was stopped by Jockeman, but Kinderchuk, with persistence, got the go-ahead goal. 2-1, Kinderchuk from... assisted goal, pardon me, as it came back off the Rangers out of that melee. I think assist should have been awarded, frankly, but so far they have not been. Unassisted at 2:27 of the second period. Philadelphia 2, New York 1. Lonsberry checks ceiling. Ceiling gets back at him and gets a faceoff in the Rangers zone. 16:57 remaining in the second period. The score, Philadelphia 2, New York Rangers 1. A good look at that, Joy, brought to you by our cameraman and director, Ted Nathanson. McLeish with Dornhofer and Lonsberry, and a hot crowd in attendance here at the Spectrum. There's a long way to go in this hockey game. 16:56 remaining in the second period. Rangers control the faceoff in their zone. Dale Ralph with the puck. McLeish going off from Lonsberry against Kachuk, Pickers, and Fairburn. Brad Park shoots it off the corner board. Van Impe is back for it. Ed Van Impe had to take on the veterans load with the injury to Barry Ashby. Long pass intended for Lonsberry, and it'll be an icing call against the Flyers. And this is an opportune time to point out that the injury last week suffered by Barry Ashby, the eye injury on the shot from Dale Rolfe. Dale, by the way, was the first man to check on the condition of Barry Ashby. He was very concerned. They were teammates in minor league hockey. And the latest word is that Barry Ashby is going to be all right. In fact, they hope to have him ready to watch today's game on television, and we hope he is. We all send him our regards. And apparently he will not have any vision impairment, and I'm sure all hockey fans are grateful to hear that. Kachuk flips it ahead, but it's stolen from Park. Here's a two-on-one break. Lonsberry in front. Skate save by Jockerman, and that was a close call. Van Impe keeps it in. Back of the goal to the corner. Fairburn checked by Dornhauser. Fairburn trying to get it to Park, who's in the corner there, but it comes out to Vickers on the left side. Vickers, number 8, slap shot, leg save by Perron, trying to get the glove on it, actually missed it with his hand, but had that leg backing up the hand. Van Impe to McLeish. McLeish flips it ahead, it's knocked down by Dale Rolfe. Rolfe for Fairburn, checked by McLeish at center ice. Van Impe dumps it in, a bouncing puck, Jockerman handles that carefully, fires it off the sideboards to Fairburn. Fairburn down the right side, Barber after him. Fairburn lost control, Bladen has it. Team changing on the move. Fairburn after Bladen. Bladen tried to hit Nolet, but it went to Nielsen of New York, who shoots it into the Flyer zone. Andre Dupont up for Barber. He missed the pass. Gilbert keeps it in. Gilbert off the leg of Sealing. It rebounds out to center ice. Nielsen shoots it into the corner. Perron holds it up for Dupont. Dupont stick handling away from Vic Hatfield. Feeds Nolet. Nolet checked by Hatfield. Clark follows the puck through. Still has it. Bobby Clark around two Rangers. Clark working in front. Loose puck in the crease. Finally clear to the corner by Sealing. Nolet controls to Dupont. Screen shot blocked by Rattel. Clark with a rebound. Dupont a shot off the skate of Nolet. And it goes up over the glass out of play with 14:59 to go in the second period. The score of the Philadelphia Flyers 2, the New York Rangers 1. Full face by Eddie Jockerman, and we'll try and show that one back to you here as they drop the puck a little sooner than we anticipated. Here it is. Selesky brings it in.
Kinder check there on that, got the go-ahead goal, makes the shot here, the rebound comes off of Jockerman. Schultz missed it, and then Selesky comes in. And Eddie Jockerman, with the great goaltending he has been performing for the Rangers, continues.
Don Selesky, who got the go-ahead goal in game 6, getting a close chance here again today. Close call for the Rangers. Kinderchuk, Selesky, Schultz against Kachuk, Fairburn, and Vickers. Kachuk against Kinderchuk. On the faceoff, Kinderchuk to Schultz. Schultz throws it back at the Ranger goal. Jockerman out of there. Checked by Selesky. The puck came to Rolfe. To Vickers. To Kachuk. Kachuk checked by Schultz. Puck still in there. Kachuk pulled down. A shot by Selesky high and wide. Jockerman holds on as he lost his balance. Elected wisely to hold on to that puck.
Lots of action here. Here's Selesky turning. Just gets possession of that puck and then gets a kind of a flip shot away to Jockerman. And Eddie seemed to lose his footing there, and he just held that puck to get the whistle. Here he goes, right in behind the net, and he's pushing Jockerman, who likes to roam, and then he kind of blocks him from coming back in, but the Rangers had possession of the puck.
Back live in the corner, Schultz and Kinderchuk, and Kinderchuk pinned there by Kachuk and Park. And it'll be another faceoff in Ranger territory to the right of Eddie Jockerman.
Shots again are indicating the Philadelphia Flyers have had 27 shots so far in the game. The Rangers have only had 10, and that shows you the great work that Jockerman has been doing for his club.
And this Flyer crowd applauding every unit as they leave the ice. Kinderchuk line has been a real force out there today. It's ostensibly a checking unit. The muscle men, Selesky and Schultz on the wings. Kinderchuk got the go-ahead goal, and it was good, hard forechecking work by the Flyers that set much of the pattern in the first period, and his line had much to do with that. Ceiling out for McGregor, too far. Off the stick of Van Imp, Irvin racing after it. Irvin knocks it loose, but Jim Watson is there. Jim Watson up the boards, too far from McLeish, knocked in by Ceiling, knocked out by Jim Watson. And this will be an icing call coming up against the Flyers as Nielsen goes back to get it. They'll bring it down into the Philadelphia zone where it has not been very much in this period. We've got 13:52 to go in the second period. 2-1 the score. Philadelphia on top. This is the seventh and deciding game. The winner to meet Boston in the Stanley Cup Championship Final. Young Jimmy Watson, who has not cracked under the pressure of being a rookie in Stanley Cup play and having more of the onus on him. Here's the goaltender's look at the faceoff coming up. You'll notice how Perron will keep checking that post with his hand to make sure he's exactly where he wants to be as far as the angles are concerned, how much net he's giving up. He'll bend that left leg so he can push off on it, get himself set. Each goalie with his own style. There are certain rules that they all kind of follow, and that one right there is to park out on the corner of that crease, cover that side, but be able to get over quickly with a stick to the right side of the net. Rangers control, Ceiling backhands it in, Perron holds it up. Jimmy Watson for Barber, bumped by Ceiling in there deep. Gilbert, Rangers gambling a little more inside the blue line. And so far it's paying off. Ceiling keeps it in again. Here's Rattel. Rattel's stick handling pulled down by Van Imp. There'll be a penalty. It went Van Imp. Well, Rod Ceiling's gambling paid off there as they kept the pressure on, forcing that penalty to Van Imp. 13:31 to go. John Rattel face off to the left of Perron again. Mark controls. DuPont in the corner. Slams at the puck. Can't get it out. Russo keeps it in to Gilbert. Gilbert to Brad Park. Park throws a shot. Caught by Perron. He holds on with that quick and very strong left hand.
Rattel was in front of that net trying to deflect that shot of Brad Park. And here we are, ice level from behind, watching as Perron will see it coming from Park. And he goes down, and there's Rattel moved in. Bigeon tried to get his lumber on that to change the direction of that puck.
Face off to the right of Perron with 1:50 remaining in the penalty to Van Imp. A holding call at 6:29. Barber, Clark, Joe Watson, and DuPont, the penalty killers. Rattel, Hatfield, Gilbert, Park, and Russo, the power play. Rattel controls that draw perfectly to Russo. Russo trying to get it to Gilbert off the stick of Barber. Gilbert goes to the corner to the blue line. Russo trying to get it to Rattel. He hit DuPont. Gilbert took it away from him. Joe Watson checks Gilbert. Rattel to Russo. Russo off the boards for Gilbert, but he's tied up by Joe Watson, and DuPont gets it. DuPont trying to get it out. Good play by Russo to keep it in. Gilbert to Rattel. Over to Brad Park. To Rattel. Rattel shoots. Stick save by Perron. Rebound off the sideboards. Rattel fan gets it again. Back to the blue line, Russo. Russo to Park. Park to Russo. Russo trying to get it to Rattel. Handed it to Bobby Clark, who shoots it off the glass and down the ice. 108 left in the penalty to Van Imp. On come Crisp and Flett, replacing Clark and Barber. Park comes out of there with steam, trying to get around Crisp. Got it to Fairburn ahead for Park. Too far. DuPont shoots it to center ice. Fairburn is on right wing, replacing Gilbert. Crisp checks Russo. Flett a drive, a late save by Jokinen, who gets that rebound and clears to the corner. A hot shot from Bill Flett as the Flyers stole the puck at the Ranger blue line. Fairburn to Hatfield. Hatfield at the blue line. Slap shot high. Cut by Perron. Perron skates out. Trying to clear hands it right to Russo. DuPont checks it. Russo gets it back. Russo to Hatfield. Blocked by Perron. Loose puck. Fairburn shot it over the top of the goal. Russo throws it in front. Joe Watson lost his stick. And DuPont covers it. There could be a penalty, but there's not going to be. DuPont covers that puck with no Ranger on him. And I think he got a break from Art Stoll there.
Fairburn got the shot away here, but I believe Perron got his leg or his stick on it here. And he deflected it up. He did. He got his right leg or the stick, the back of his stick, and he deflected that puck up. Fairburn almost having his second goal here in this game, and an opportunity to tie it up, but he'll never get a better one. He was right in position. Here we'll see whether he did get his stick on it or his leg. Here the puck comes out. The puck will go to Fairburn right in front. There it is. Looked a little bit like it did, Tim. I wouldn't swear on it completely.
Hard to say on that one whether Billy just shot it over the net. He was trying to get it up over the goaltender, as you could see. And Perron, as usual, not giving him much to shoot at. So it remains 2-1. 22 seconds left in the penalty. Kachuk against Clark on the faceoff. Kachuk, Vickers, and Fairburn. Clark controls to DuPont, who shot it right to ceiling. Ceiling a drive, an arm save by Perron. And that blast from the point. Out comes Barber. Barber with Clark. Three Rangers are back, so Barber now cruising around, using up 4 seconds. Now throws it in, and Jockman controls. 6 seconds left in the penalty, and the Flyers are going to survive this power play chance by New York. Fairburn down the right side. Van Imp back on. Fairburn a shot. Stick save, rebound. Vickers, backhander, sliding save by Perron on the rebound. Try wide. And Perron made a big save there after he gave up a bad rebound. And Vickers breaking in, but Perron was up to it and made that sliding stop. Teams at full strength, McGregor trying to get loose. Jimmy Watson stopped that and poked it over the boards and out of play.
The thing about Perron, which he doesn't do, is give that rebound, and here you see the rebound go right back out. Then he sprawls here, making a good save on Irvin, and then the puck comes over to Vickers. Here's the rebound again. And he lays down, making the save on Vickers. Number 8 there, moving in on that backhand.
The crowd here giving a standing ovation to the scoreboard sign that indicates their goalie, Bernie Perron, was named to the All-Star team of the West Division in the Sporting News, which is polled by the players in the National Hockey League. And their defenseman, Barry Ashby, has also been selected to that team by the players, and that's fine tribute to those great pair of Flyers. Jimmy Watson ahead for Dave Schultz. Schultz, number 8, over center ice, shoots it off the corner board. Selesky after it. Nielsen there ahead of him, beat him to it. Nielsen to Stemkowski, ahead for Ted Irvin. Irvin with McGregor on the right wing with him. Irvin over the line, gives it to McGregor, overskates the puck as he's checked by Schultz. The puck now, Selesky and Stemkowski battling for it. Kinderchuk to Schultz. Dave Schultz trying to get the shot. He does. Stick save by Jockman. As Nielsen was on him, Schultz didn't have much power on the shot. Irvin down the left side, feeds McGregor, couldn't hold the pass. Jim Watson clears the center ice. Schultz shoots it in. End-to-end action here, midway through the second period. 2-1, Philadelphia leads it. On a second period goal by Kinderchuk. Stemkowski ahead to McGregor, broken up by DuPont. Ceiling to Nielsen. Nielsen to McGregor, off his skates, stolen by DuPont. DuPont, one man back, a drive. Blake saved by Jockman, rebound cleared by Ceiling. Flyers keeping it in. McGregor can't get out. Schultz has it. Check by Ceiling. Stemkowski comes out. Stemkowski stick handling away from Kinderchuk. Flips it into the Flyer zone. Teams change on the move. Perron holds it up for Tom Layton. Layton number 3. Rink wide pass for Lonsberry, but an offside pass from inside the blue line over the center red line. 9:48 to go in the second period. The score, Philadelphia 2, the New York Rangers 1. Against McLeish on the rim of the circle where that offside pass originated. Kachuk got the draw. It came behind Dale Rolfe. He has to go back to his own line to get it. Rolfe off McLeish's leg. McLeish to Dornhoff for to Lonsberry. Stopped by Rolfe, and Vickers starts out. And he runs into his old man Kachuk. Stolen by Lonsberry. To McLeish, too far. Park takes over. Jockman feeds it out to Fairburn. Fairburn in the middle of Kachuk. Kachuk to Vickers, an offside at the Flyers' line. And Vickers was in there a stride ahead of the puck. Kachuk, Vickers, Fairburn against McLeish, Lonsberry, and Dornhofer. Our coverage of WCT 74 concludes next Sunday at 1 o'clock Eastern Time, a 3-hour telecast of the finals from Dallas, Texas. And we'll be on with Stanley Cup Finals action following that. Here's McLeish with a breakaway. McLeish has a break. He shoots it. Jockman made the save. Jockman won the showdown with McLeish, and he's forced to the corner. Rangers trying to get a faceoff there, but the puck is loose. Park can't get it out. DuPont a drive. Too wide by McLeish, who got back into the slot. What a game he's having. Cleared out of there finally by Kachuk to center ice. DuPont has it. DuPont off the boards for Lonsberry. Lonsberry trying to get around Park. Park cuts him off. Puck knocked back to the Ranger goal by Lonsberry. Jockman checked there by Dornhofer. Dale Rolfe hands it right to McLeish. He's all over the place. McLeish is front again. McLeish shoots. Dornhofer scores. Gary Dornhofer. And it's 3-1 Philadelphia. And Rick McLeish did all the work on that one with a fantastic display of perseverance and anticipation. Gary Dornhofer makes it 3-1.
McLeish.
Nash, who missed that breakaway on that showdown. Here we'll see his work. Here Dornhofer gives a little pass to McLeish. He shoots it. Jockman makes the save. McLeish takes another shot. And then Dornhofer, number 12, puts it over. And after all, you only let, here it is. Come back to McLeish. Back out. You only ask your goaltender to make one save, and Jockman made three before Dornhofer put that puck in. There's a little pass to McLeish, comes back to him, and Dornhofer, anticipating it, moved in very quickly as Rolf didn't get to him fast enough.
Dornhofer from McLeish, Dornhofer's fourth playoff goal. No way, stopped at the blue line as a feed for him too far, and a puck goes out of play off the stick of Van Imp. And let's go down and join Brian McFarland. Down here, he wears a goal mask in the crowd. Are you afraid of getting hit by a puck?
No, I'm just here for Bernie. He's my favorite player. He's doing great in the series, and that's why I'm helping him.
Now you got this glass protecting you, too. Let's see what you look like underneath that mask.
Our man, Bernie.
Isn't he a handsome devil? Back up to you, Jim.
He'll help us.
Well, these Flyer fans are enjoying it so far. 8:19 to go. 3-1 Philadelphia. Dornhofer from McLeish at 11:26. And that Rick McLeish really worked to set up that goal after he missed a breakaway chance. Icing call against the Rangers. Pete Stemkowski back of the goal complaining about it, but icing charge against New York. And McLeish made his break there, made a good play. Jockman made a great stop on him as he gave him about three moves. And Eddie stayed right with him, but McLeish just kept battling until he got another chance.
Well, on the breakaway, Tim, he stumbled a little bit just about center ice, and it didn't give him a chance to get right out into the center and go straight in. He was cut off to the side a little bit, and Eddie closed the angle and anticipated what he was going to do all the way.
What a great effort by McLeish, who now has a goal and an assist here in the Ranger zone. It's taken by Kindrachuk in front for Selesky, checked by Seeling, and Stemkowski gets it to Irvin. Irvin to McGregor. McGregor over the line, poke checked on him by Jim Watson. Kindrachuk takes over. Kindrachuk up the boards for Schultz. Schultz missed the pass, Seeling keeps it in. Over the stick of Jimmy Watson, McGregor into the slot. Irvin too well covered by Van Imp, and Kindrachuk gets it. Kindrachuk checked by Irvin, it goes down. Stemkowski keeps it in. Van Imp broke up the first try. Stemkowski to McGregor, checked by Jim Watson. Schultz comes out the left side. Stick handles away from Stemkowski. All the fans love that. He's not noted for his stick handling. Nielsen gets a piece of him. Schultz goes to the corner, throws it in front. Selesky a shot, chucking and save on Don Selesky as Schultz made the play, and the fans really love that.
Schultz made that play from end to end. He has improved himself tremendously as a hockey player, but he's done it by hard work. And here you'll see him going around the defense, going into the corner, going around Nielsen. Then he takes a look as he goes to the puck, which is the wise thing to do. Gets it out to Selesky here. And Jockman has to come up with another save. And Kindrachuk is right there looking for that rebound.
Back live, Terry Crisp. Center ice with the rookie Cowick, number 27, and Bill Flint, number 21. The fourth line out there for the Flyers against Patel, Hatfield, and Gilbert. Brad Park with Chris Moore checking in deep. Trying to get it to Hatfield. Flint broke it up, and the Flyers get another faceoff in the Rangers' zone. And they continue to keep the pressure on. They have outshot New York 34-17 so far in the game.
And up until this game, the most shots in any game that the Philadelphia Club have had are 23. Tim, so it shows you shots on goals give you that advantage.
They did not shoot well in the games in New York. Gilbert pokes it away from DuPont, racing after it. Joe Watson back in the Flyer zone, got ahead of it. Patel tried to keep it in, but the puck came over the blue line. Offside call with Gilbert and Hatfield both inside the Flyer zone. 34-17, the shots are kept cumulatively here on this scoreboard. And that's literally double the output by the Flyers here, who have a 3-1 lead that is reflected in the shots on goal. That's not always the case, but it sure is here today. Rattel got the faceoff and got through DuPont. Rattel battling in there. DuPont staying with him. And DuPont finally falls on the puck with Rattel on him. And they'll face it off in Flyers territory. 6:49 to go here in the second period.
The Rangers are not dead yet. Fellas like Rattel out there, he's forcing him. He almost forced DuPont to make a mistake there, which would have given Rattel a good opportunity.
Well, they have come back from two-goal deficits before in this series and also in the Montreal series to win the game. And I'm sure Fred Chura will be reminding his Flyers of that as this game proceeds. 3-1 is not a big margin when you've got the firepower the New York Rangers have. Rattel against Clark. Rangers control. Gilbert to Park. Park over to Rolfe. Rolfe tried to roll it through. It went off the leg of Joe Watson. Rattel trying to get possession. Back of the goal. Joe Watson covers him. Gilbert forces Watson to throw it to the right wing side. Nolet dumped it out. It went off the stick of Hatfield and came all the way back into the Rangers zone. Hatfield, back of the goal, a pass too far for Park, taken by Clark, rolls it in front of the stick of Rolfe. Nolet a drive blocked by Hatfield. Luke puts up to get control. Shoots it off the board. Up for Hatfield. Hatfield trying to get started. Nolet after him, catches up and takes it away. Loose puck picked up by Clark. Clark for Nolet. It's a breakaway. Nolet shoots in. Jockman made the save. It covers on the rebound. As Barber trying to slip it in. Eddie Jockman comes up big again as that pesky, persistent, hard-skating Flyer squad again making another opportunity for themselves.
Nolet on the back-checking. That's what back-checking's all about. Made the play. He got the puck to Clark. Here Clark gets the puck to Nolet, who goes in there. He didn't get a real good shot away, but Jockman was ready for anything. And Barber trying to go in there for the rebound to knock it into the net, but Eddie had it covered up very well.
The impressive thing about this club is that they're always going towards the opposition net. Whenever the puck is even loose, they head for the opposition goal. Nolet made the check, but then circled around to his off-wing side and broke into the Rangers' zone, allowing Clark to get him that pass at full stride. Here's Lonsbury doing the same thing, breaking right in. Drop pass for McLeish. Return pass for Dornhofer. That just missed. In the corner, Vickers to Kachuk. Kachuk for New York, out to Fairburn, number 10. Billy Fairburn cuts to his off-wing side, stick handling. Still has it, finally lost it as Dornhofer came over to help. Dornhofer runs into Kachuk. Layton has the puck. Over to DuPont. DuPont off the boards. Nobody open. It goes to ceiling of New York. Over to Nielsen. Nielsen, number 15, in the middle of Kachuk. Kachuk shoots it off the stick of DuPont. 5:25 remaining in the second period. Lonsbury back of his own net. Forechecking by Fairburn forces it the other way. Up the boards for DuPont. Andre DuPont. Over to Dornhofer. Too far. Into the New York territory. Nielsen back for it. The Selesky line with Schultz and Kindrachuk coming on. Nielsen's pass intended for Fairburn too far. This will be an icing call against New York. 5 minutes exactly remaining in the second period. The score, Philadelphia 3, the New York Rangers 1. First, when this game is over for these clubs, neither team has ever won a seventh game in a playoff series in their entire club history. So one of them is going to achieve that here this afternoon. Rolfe to Stemkowski. Stemkowski back to Dale Rolfe in full flight at center ice. Return to Stemkowski, too far ahead of him. He gets it in the corner. Throws it in front. It's blocked by Kinderchuk. Stemkowski tries again. It's deflected over the glass and out of play. Stemkowski with Irvin and Ron Harris on the right wing, number 3, against Kindrachuk, Selesky, and Schultz.
Fred Sherrill has many slogans on the blackboard in the Philadelphia room, and in there yesterday, Tim, he had one that he really likes, is take a direct route to the puck and arrive in ill humor.
That about says it all for the style of the Flyers. Park, good move away from Schultz. Park does it again. Kindrachuk stays with that one, and it's taken by Jimmy Watson to hit the linesman trying to get it out, and it's Kindrachuk. Too far for Selesky. Park gave Kindrachuk a little bump after the play. Dale Rolfe sets up back of the New York goal. Rolfe to Stemkowski. Gets away from Kindrachuk. Meets Stemkowski. He's been the most consistent forward for New York in this series. Harris a shot. Stick saved by Perron. But Harris has a sneaky wrist shot that he can get away with power. Selesky shoots it in. Off the boards. Cowick, the rookie out there on left wing, has replaced Schultz. Harris trying to get away from Selesky, can't do it. Crisp keeps it in. Crisp has replaced Kindrachuk at center. Irvin intended for Stemkowski, too far, and Cowick gave Irvin a run into the board. Van Impe intended for Flint. That goes deep into the Rangers zone. Jockman moves away from Crisp as he faked one way and came the other. Irvin trying to get it out. Joe Watson keeps it in. Jockman throws it away from Crisp. Rolfe up the boards as Cowick stepped into Harris. They had a few bumps in game 6 in the rookie's first game for Philadelphia. Crisp keeps it in. Flyers keep that pressure on. Jockman gives it to Dale Rolfe. New York having difficulty moving that puck out of their zone. Russo is on now at center ice. The feed from Rawl to Irvin. Number 27, Forsberg off right wing side, takes a shot wide. Off the boards, Nielsen gambles in. Chris checked him, the puck came over the glass and out of play. Ron Harris and Bruce Kauf, the rookie, showing a little muscle they demonstrated in game six.
There's Harris moving out, and there's Kauf, who hit Ron in New York, but Kauf went down, and he probably looked at that little guy and couldn't figure out how strong he was. Yeah, a lot of our viewers might wonder why that offside wasn't called and went back into the Rangers' end with the Philadelphia player caught there. It was a New York player that brought it back into the end, and then this does not constitute an offside.
Gowick is 6'1 and 200 pounds, 23 years of age, rescued from the minor leagues by Philadelphia in a four-man deal. Near miss there as Nolet almost got loose. McGregor made a good play to break it up. Russo stopped by DuPont. Barber takes over, stopped by Nielsen. Inside the flyer line, Nolet. Nolet for Clark, steers it into New York territory. Racing after the pair of 16, ceiling is there. Whirls away from Clark. Up to Butler. Jerry Butler, number 17, the rookie right wing, on with Russo and McGregor. Russo's stick handling. Checked by DuPont, goes to the corner. DuPont gives him a good hip check and comes off with the puck. DuPont around the boards. Too far for Joe Watson. Nielsen a shot wide. Off the backboard to rebound to Barber. Bill Barber, number 7, checked from behind by McGregor. Bouncing puck picked up by McGregor. McGregor takes a shot and a late save as Perron had to be alert on that shot from McGregor. Headed low to the corner. It's flipped out by DuPont down into New York territory. 3-1 the score. Philadelphia in front, 2:15 left in the second period. Butler ahead to Rattel. Rattel lost control. Van Imp clears to the Ranger line. Rattel, Hatfield now. Gilbert steps on. Nielsen to the flyer line. Van Imp shoots it to Dornhofer. Dornhofer handed it right to Nielsen of New York, who gives it back to Philadelphia's Watson. Jim Watson to McLeish. McLeish for Dornhofer. Couldn't quite catch up with the pass. In the corner, throws it in front for McLeish too far. Kept in by Jimmy Watson. Deflected shot. Cleared by Sealing out to Hatfield. Hatfield down the left side. Shoots it off the corner boards. And Gilbert after it. Lonsbury covering him. Loose puck, Gilbert. Gilbert to the blue line to Park. Good pass. Over to Dale Rolfe. Hatfield knocked down in front. Rolfe shot off Van Imp's leg. Lonsbury checked by Gilbert. Gilbert doing some hard work for New York. Here's Hatfield banned on the shot. And Rolfe batted to him in the slot. Hatfield gives Jim Watson a good shoulder check. McLeish and Rattel go down. Lonsbury clears it out of the flyer zone as New York started to get some pressure on. 1:13 left in the period. Icing will be called against the Flyers.
New York starting to put a little bit of pressure on, trying to get a goal here before the end of that period. Here again is Clark. Just moves into the man. Even though he's made the pass, he just delays him just a little bit and follows that puck. He and Bruce McGregor.
McGregor got a pretty good grab on his stick there to make sure that Clark didn't get loose. Captain of the Flyers, Bobby Clark, who has had an outstanding playoff series, although not so much in the scoring department. When he does as much as he does, you know he's very much in the game at all times. Joe Watson and his brother Jim giving strong defensive play to the Flyers here this afternoon. Goaltender's view again of that faceoff coming up. Bobby Clark this time against Walt Kachuk.
Their dad is here, the Watson brothers. He's from Smithers, B.C. Took about a 30-hour train ride to Calgary and then flew into the Philadelphia here.
Mr. Watson Sr. is a lumberjack up in that beautiful woods country of British Columbia, Canada. A lot of viewers looking in there this afternoon. We're sure we'd like to say hello to all of our Canadian viewers who've been watching NBC's telecast all season long. Bill Barber out to Dale Rolfe of the Rangers as he tried to hit Selesky with a long pass. Went right to Rolfe. He's playing Vickers. Vickers to Kachuk. Over to Fairburn. Fairburn off the board. Right to DuPont of the Flyers. We're in the final minute of period two. 3-1. The Flyers lead. Seventh game of this semifinal series. Brad Park brings it in. Park over the line for Kachuk. Bumped off the puck by Joe Watson, and Perron dives out on it before Vickers can make a play. 45 seconds left. They played Kate Smith's God Bless America prior to the game, and Kate's record here on behalf of the Flyers, 34 wins, 3 losses, and 1 tie. Pretty impressive good luck charm for the Flyers. This was the big one today, and their boss of the building here, the Spectrum, Lou Scheinfeld, elected to play Kate Smith today, and the fans were out in force with banners like that one.
With the superstition, though, Ed Jockman said that he was going to wear his old brown suit with the blue stripe, and the smelly suit would probably outdo Kate Smith. Superstitions prevailed.
3-1, the Flyers hold the lead, but there's lots of hockey left in this one. Joe Watson, as Clark got the faceoff, takes it back of the Flyer goal. Not only one penalty in this series, there were 10 in the first period. 33 seconds remaining. Here's Bobby Clark, one man back, it's Rolfe. Clark takes a shot high and caught easily by Jockman. Jockman gives it off to Brad Park. 25 seconds left, Fairburn. Fairburn rink wide to Vickers. Vickers trying to get around Joe Watson, takes the shot deflected by Watson, and it goes over the glass and out of play. Vickers took a long shot from the side boards there, and Joe Watson didn't really have too much trouble getting the stick on him. This program note from NBC, John Saxon goes undercover to break a phony credit card and blackmail ring this week on Police Story, Tuesday night at 10, 9 Central Time, here on NBC. Well, that's one Flyers fan's view of Eddie Jockman's superstition. That's too delicate. Eddie's suit may not be, for that matter. Zemkowski against Clark. To the right of Bernie Perron. Perron slaps that pad. Zemkowski got the draw. This time a shot by Nielsen wide. Ceiling can't get there to keep it in. 11 seconds left. Ceiling intended for Irvin, offside called at the Flyer line again with 9 seconds remaining.
We have two fine linesmen in this game today, D'Amico and Pavlich. They've had some close ones, but they recognize the importance of this game, and they've really done a good job in calling them.
The minor officials today are from Pittsburgh, who worked the Pittsburgh Penguin games during the regular season. The home officials are not used during Stanley Cup play. The goal judges, the official scorer, and other minor officials are always brought in from one of the other NHL cities. And they are rotated through the playoffs. Dornhofer gets control, a low drive, and that tested Jockman. He got the glove on it. And clears to the corner as the buzzer sounds, ending the second period of play at the Spectrum in Philadelphia, where the score is the Philadelphia Flyers 3, the New York Rangers 1. So the Rangers trailing 3-1, up against it now, 20 minutes of hockey to go here. If they can tie it up, they can force an overtime. And of course, there's plenty of time for them to win the game in regulation time. Let's see what happens. Rattel, Gilbert, and Hadfield against Clark, Barber, and Nolet. Clark intended for Nolet, intercepted by Hadfield. His pass too far for Rattel. And Jim Watson goes back into the Flyer zone. Around the board right to Hadfield. He missed it, but Dale Rolfe has it. Rolfe down the board for Hadfield, trying to get it into the slot to Rattel, still battling with Nolet all over him, and Nolet takes it away. Nolet works his way up the left wing side. He's a good skater, as you can see. Has Barber with him. Drop pass, shot blocked in front, and it goes to the sideboard. Gilbert is there with Barber and Park, and Park has it underneath him. There'll be a faceoff in Ranger territory. We'd like to correct one incorrect statistic we gave you earlier in the game. The team that had scored the first goal in the last four games of the series wound up on the losing end of that game, and we were pointing that out when New York scored first here today at 13:43 of the first period, Fairburn. And so far that pattern is continuing, but we should also point out that the Rangers have come from behind two goal deficits to win in this series as well. So we've got 19:28 to go in regulation time.
And in the first six games of this series, the Rangers have scored most of their goals in the third period. They've got 3, 4, and 6 in the third period, whereas Philadelphia have had 6, 6, and 6, equal in the first, second, and third period.
New York controls this faceoff. Nielsen is checked by Lonsberry, and Lonsberry takes it away, trying to throw it in front, blocked by Jockman. Kachuk and Lonsberry and Nielsen. Nielsen pries it loose. Ceiling goes for it. Ceiling in the corner is watched there by Dornhofer. Gets away from Dornhofer the other way. Dornhofer catches up with him. Great forechecking by the Flyers again. McLeish, a shot at the side of the goal. Dornhofer checked heavily by Nielsen. Ceiling comes in to help. And Lonsberry, and they hold it for a faceoff again. And you cannot see a more dramatic example of what works for the Flyers in that little session there.
Just the effort of Dornhofer there, just kept that puck in there and kept New York bottled up. He didn't give Seeling a chance to get control of the puck where he could get it to his man. Just kept pressure. Here it is right here. As Seeling tries to turn around, then Dornhofer keeps right at him. Puck comes right back in.
Back live. Rangers finally get over their blue line. Kachuk checked by McLeish and Fairburn. His pass blocked by Lonsbury. Sealing pokes it ahead. It's right to Flyers' Joe Watson. McLeish controlling to Dornhofer. Dornhofer cuts over to the left wing side. Backhands it in, and the Flyers want to make a change. McLeish, however, stays out there and chases Sealing back of the Ranger goal. Sealing to Vickers. Kachuk, Vickers, and Fairburn. This is Kachuk. Kachuk trying to get around Joe Watson. Can't do it. Puck inside the blue line, offside call against New York. 18:24 to go in the second period. With the score, the Philadelphia Flyers 3 and the New York Rangers 1. Rangers control this faceoff. Stemkowski on with McGregor and Irvin. McGregor going to the corner. Hinderchuk is there. McGregor checking against him. Irvin tries it loose to Park at the blue line. Park a shot blocked in front by Jimmy Watson. Dale Walf off the boards. Knocks to the corner. Stemkowski. Stemkowski out to the blue line, but between the defense pair of Park and Walf, and thus down into the Rangers zone. Park back for it. Right in front of his own net to Rolfe with a dangerous pass, the way these Flyers forecheck. Stemkowski, a long shot off the backboard. Jimmy Watson can't get it out. Park, here's Irvin, a shot. Irvin covers on it, grabs it before Stemkowski can get it. Zaleski and Stemkowski going at each other at the end boards, and the linesmen jump in to separate them. Zaleski checking Stemkowski right as Stemkowski tried to knock the puck out of Perron's glove. And the two of them wound up at the back boards jawing each other. Linesmen are in there, Matt Pavlich and John Amico, to get them separated.
Zaleski probably taking a little bit of offense the fact that Stemkowski tried to knock that rebound past Perrant as Irvin held that puck. We'll see that play again. Here it is. Irvin almost got the puck past. Then you'll see Stemkowski just taking a jab at it. He got the elbow up. I think that was probably more than anything, the fact that he got the elbow up into Selesky's face.
I think he heard the footsteps behind him. 17:44 to go in the second period. The score, Philadelphia 3, New York 1. Perron, Selesky, and Stemkowski get two-minute minors for roughing at 2:16 of this third period. And the teams are playing five aside. Bill Flett battling with Brad Park. Terry Crisp comes up with a number 15. Over to Bladen. Bladen off the stick of Dale Rolfe and offside. Call at the New York blue line. Bill Flett demoted to the fourth line. He's just simply been having problems with his productivity in these playoffs. Did not have a great year for the Flyers. But Fred Sherrill gives everybody ice time. And even though he's now not with Barber and Clark as he normally is, he's still getting his share out there with Crisp and the rookie Kowak when they play as a full unit. Rattel to Gilbert. Off the skates, it goes to DuPont. DuPont ahead, handed it right to Brad Park. Park spinning away from Crisp with some of that nifty stick handling and skating ability he shows. Rolfe's pass off the stick of Flett, taken by Crisp. Terry Crisp, rink-wide pass. Off the boards, Flett has it. Flett bumped by Gilbert, and Skov, the referee, got in the middle of that one. Flyers throw it in. Jockeman controlling around the boards right to Bladen. Bladen the shot, and that really tested Jockeman. Got his glove and stick on it to knock down the hot drive from the blue line. Rolfe trying to get out. Flett checking him. He dumps Park. Park's caught up in the mesh. His skate caught in the mesh. Park trying to get a faceoff. Finally knocked it around very cleverly to Jockeman, who held on. Getting a faceoff. Park will get some assistance back there, getting himself out of that goal net.
Park made a good play. His stick was just long enough there where he could hook the puck out to Jockeman so he could get that whistle. Here you'll see as Flett cuts him off here, took the feet out from under him a little bit there. And there's where the heel of his skate got caught on the net as he tried to reach it. And then Rolfe takes Flett right into the boards here.
Six seconds left in the penalties to Zaleski and Stemkowski. Bobby Clark against Walt Kachuk.
Here it is again. There's the shot off Bladen, and Jockeman made that save as he goes out of the net. And here we'll see Park. There's where the heel of his skate got caught. We're back to live action.
Van Imp to Jim Watson. Watson over to Van Imp. 3-1, the Flyers lead. We're in the third period at the Spectrum. Jim Watson beating Bobby Clark, checked by Ron Harris. Fairburn, Harris is out on defense now with Nielsen, his first shift on defense. He is normally a defenseman. but Emil Francis uses him up front as well. Clark in the corner throws it in front, but Kachuk is there. Kachuk breaks out. Nielsen gave Clark a pretty good ride in the corner. Kachuk is tripped by Clark. There'll be a penalty, and he knew it. As soon as he put that stick down at Kachuk's skates, Clark knew he was gone, and sorry that he had done it. 17 seconds left in the twin penalties to Selesky and Stemkowski, so New York will have a man advantage, 5-4, and then 6-5, when the first penalties expire.
There it is, as he got the stick right at his ankle and took the feet out from under Kachuk, and Clark is very mad at himself. This gives, there it is again, took the feet right out from under Walt, and this will give New York a chance to get right back in this game with a power play that hasn't been very productive, but every opportunity that you give them, it makes it one more chance closer.
Bobby Clark hooking is the call, 3:59. Face off at the Flyer line, and it's taken by Lonsberry away from Rattel, who shot it to the Ranger line. Now Rousseau to Gilbert. Gilbert slip shot, leg save for Roth on a good hard shot from Gilbert. Rebound all the way to Park. Rangers with the extra man. Rousseau a drive, skate save by Curdy Perron again. Back comes Selesky. Park over to Rousseau. Stemkowski and Selesky are on. Here's the feed to Stemkowski. Stemkowski a shot blocked by Jimmy Watson. Rebounds to Lonsberry. Advantage. Russo comes up quickly. Lonsberry and Crisp, the penalty killers. Russo, Dick Kelly in offside. Mattel ahead of the puck carrier Russo. 1:20 left in the penalty.
That last, here's young Jim Watson. We talked to him about earlier in the game. Here's the save, I should say, by Gilbert. That's a little bit earlier. And the foot save by Perron. But just before this whistle, young Jim Watson made a good sprawling defensive play.
Stopping Pete Stemkowski, who just come out of the penalty box. Rattel, Gilbert, Hatfield, Park, and Russo, the power play. Terry Crisp on the faceoff for the Philadelphia Flyers. Crisp gets it to DuPont, who shoots it down the ice. Dockerman holding it up for Russo. 3-1, Philadelphia leading. 15:09 to go in the third period. The seventh game of the Stanley Cup semifinal. Gilbert to Rattel. Checked from behind by Crisp, and the puck knocked out to center ice. Flyers have controlled this game throughout. They have outshot New York 38-22. Rattel, as D'Amico, the linesman, has dumped in a collision with Hatfield, but the linesman really doing his work. He made the offside call anyway as he was falling down. John D'Amico.
He didn't get all the wind onto the whistle. There was a little weak there for Hatfield when over the line just ahead of it, and then he took the feet out from under D'Amico as he knocked him down, and there's John. As we've mentioned before, certainly the strongest linesman of all of them, and does a real fabulous job of calling.
He had a hold of Dave Schultz in a fight in this series, earlier in the series. Schultz said after the game, the reason I went after my man again was because I was so frustrated from being unable to get away from D'Amico. He said he's so strong, his arms were choking me, and by the time I got loose, I was so mad I went after my man again.
That's a testimonial of D'Amico's strength when Schultz gives him that compliment.
That's right. Schultz wound up with a misconduct for his troubles on the play. Face off at the Flyer blue line. D'Amico had to do some house cleaning. These guys do everything out there. Stemkowski lost his balance, and an interception by Lonsberry racing after it, and the Rangers own a shot. Wide of the goal. Jockman had taken the angle from him, and he tried for the wide side but missed it. Park comes out. 37 seconds left of the penalty to Bobby Clark. Brad Park shoots it off the corner boards. Perron comes out of the net to hold it up for his teammates. His feed intended for Lonsberry comes through, but Park has it at the blue line of Fairburn. Fairburn a shot right on, and Perron made the save and covered on the rebound. 21 seconds remain, and a hooking penalty to Clark.
Perron very quickly got on that rebound with his man, team a man short. Here's the play by Park. As it was into Fairburn. Fairburn gets a good shot away that bounces away from Perron here, and then he jumps right on it very quickly.
The crowd chanting Bernie, 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 something they picked up from the Madison Square Garden fans who have had that same chant for Eddie Jockman. Eddie, Eddie. And both these goalies can go away from this series knowing they have turned in some of the best Stanley Cup goaltending in a long time. They've both been great. Jockman here today has been spectacular. McLeish got that faceoff and drilled it right down the ice. Jockeman off the boards for Fairburn. Fairburn leaves it for Stemkowski, who comes in with speed over the line, breaks on, left side feed, Kachuk, the drive, big save, rebound, cleared away by Jimmy Watson. Perron came up with another big one on Kachuk. Stemkowski as the Rangers keep it in. Down to the corner for Fairburn. Clark is back on. Hit front, Clark shoots. Perron made the save, a pileup with the crease, and he holds on to the rebound. Purdy, Perron with another brilliant save. 13:54 to go in the third period to score Philadelphia 3. The New York Rangers 1. We're back live now with Russo against Kindrychuk and somebody in that face-off circle, and all of these face-offs now are crucial, so the linesman and referee school will be calling them close. You must stay outside that circle till the puck is dropped. Kindrychuk against Russo. Russo gets it back to Sealing. Sealing a drive wide. Rebound all the way to Dale Rolfe. Rolfe kept it in. Down the boards for Irvin. Irvin to Russo. Russo tried to center. It comes to Selesky. Poke check on him by Irvin. Good effort by Irvin. Knocks it to the corner. DuPont back for it. Rangers forward checking now. DuPont overskates it. McGregor working against him. Puck loose back of the goal and held long enough for a whistle. Art Skov lost sight of it, and so he blew that whistle.
Skov shook his head. He knew that he called it. He didn't see Kindrychuk coming out loose with the puck. He knew he made a mistake, but the puck was on the other side of the net, and he thought it was frozen.
This is Bernie Perrant getting set for the faceoff in the corner. Goes through that whole ritual there, banging his pads, his gloves, checking where the post is, knocking his mask into position. Got a whole number he goes through, and it all works, evidently. Faceoff to the right. Russo again controls. Park, a rolling shot, didn't get much on it off the heel of his stick. Joe Watson shoots it out for Schultz, off his leg to Selesky. Kindrychuk, Schultz, and Selesky against Russo, Irvin, and McGregor. Russo flips it over his line. Selesky gets it and shoots it in for the Flyers. Park, back of his own goal, lugging it out of there. You'll see him do this the rest of the way. He knows he's got to lead this attack. They're down by two. He gets through one man, but DuPont stops him. Selesky shoots it, and it goes over the glass and out of play. 13:03 to go in the third period. The Flyers lead by two.
In this game.
From this faceoff, a bouncing puck taken by Nolet. He breaks out of there with a turn of speed. He has Barber with him. Backhand pass right to Harris of New York. Harris, stick handles by one man, gives it to Rattel. Rattel has Gilbert with him. Rattel goes with backhand side, can't get around Jimmy Watson, who takes him into the boards. Puck taken by Barber. Barber back of his own goal. Nolet with Gilbert. Gilbert tried to get it to Hatfield. Nolet broke it up. Nielsen a drive right on, caught by Vermont. He gives it to Van Imp. Van Imp up the boards, Barber. Barber, Harris gambling in deep. Harris still scrapping, but Clark is there with Gilbert. The Rangers keep it in. Hatfield takes a hitter shot by Rattel wide. Jimmy Watson with it. Rangers pressing here. Good forechecking. Harris controls to Nielsen. Nielsen waits for Rattel to get onside. Shoots it in again. New York changing on the move. Jimmy Watson gets it out to Barber too far. Fairburn has it. Fairburn with Clark checking him. Fairburn breaks away. Fairburn down the left side of the slot. Pickers can't get the shot away. Checked from behind by Clark. Simon Ollet takes over, and the Rangers with great pressure here. Park. Park, the shot is blocked by Bobby Clark. McLeish comes on, replacing Clark. The rebound went to Nielsen. Nielsen to Kachuk, missed the pass. Jimmy Watson in front of his own goal. Throws it out to center ice. Nielsen intercepts. New York really taking over the play here. Van Imp breaks it up and clears it down the ice. And the fans applauding that play, which was the best defensive play in the last 2 minutes by the Flyers, as the Rangers are desperate here, and they're pouring it on. Walter Kachuk comes up with Vickers and Fairburn. Long shot, stick save by Bernie Perron, gives it to DuPont. DuPont back of his own goal, checked there by Fairburn, but the puck knocked out the center ice by the Flyers. Park feeds Vickers. Rangers now turning right back every chance they get. Kachuk in there battling. Over to Fairburn. Fairburn to Kachuk. Kachuk over to Vickers. Score! Steve Vickers from Waller. Kachuk on a brilliant pass. Fairburn and Vickers and Kachuk combining there, and the Rangers are back in it here with 11:11 to go. Vickers makes it 3-2 Philadelphia.
As we were talking, the Rangers just keeping that pressure on, and this puts them right back in this hockey. There's Fairburn getting the pass over to Kachuk. Kachuk putting it perfectly to Vickers, who puts it in the short side. Perron didn't have a chance on that one. Here again, is the play by Fairburn. Over to Vickers from Kachuk and into the net, and it's a 3-2 hockey game.
Tremendous play by Kachuk, Vickers, and Fairburn. As Kachuk measured that pass perfectly right between the legs of Joe Watson, and that gave Vickers his shot. He had a man hanging on him, but he pulled the trigger. Short side goal makes it 3-2. Centering pass score!
The play, you'll see Lonsbury, number 18, getting it, giving it perfectly to Dornhofer, who gets his fifth goal of the playoffs, the second of the afternoon, and that very quickly gives Philadelphia that two-man advantage. Here's Lonsbury, right out perfectly. Jockerman didn't have a chance as Dornhofer was all alone there. Great block, Barkov. Rolf moved back in there to get Lonsbury, and Dornhofer found himself all alone in front of that net.
Dornhofer scoring with assist from Lonsbury and McLeish.
Lonsbury and McLeish get the assist at 9:01. Dornhofer's fifth goal of the series of the Stanley Cup playoffs makes it 4-2, and the Flyers gain right back. Crisp against Stemkowski. Stemkowski controls to Nielsen. Nielsen to Harris. Harris to Stemkowski. Long shot by Stemkowski, handled easily by Perron. Van Imp out for Terry Crisp. Crisp with Kindrychuk and Selesky. A mixed line here for the Flyers. Kindrychuk for Selesky, and it's offside at the Ranger blue line. 10:40 to go in the third period with the score Philadelphia 4. The New York Rangers 2. They just scored that goal. All right, Rangers control this faceoff. They trail 4-2, two-goal deficit again. Jimmy Watson off the boards, right to Ron Harris. Harris, pass intended for Stemkowski, and Matt Pavlich whistled it. I think it was touched off the ice in front of the Ranger bench. Terry Crisp looking around quizzically. The Flyers have had only two shots so far in this third period. The Rangers have had 10. And although the Flyers have outshot them 39-29, the Rangers have been making the comeback here. McGregor steals from Kindrychuk. Stemkowski has it in on goal. Centering pass for Irvin. Too well covered. A drive by Nielsen. Leg save. Loose puck. Stemkowski after it. A pile up in front. And that puck is under somebody's body. I can't begin to tell you whose, but I wouldn't be surprised if it's Perron's.
Skov, there wasn't going to be any arguments on a questionable goal. Skov was right on the goal post, watching it all the way.
We're getting those faceoffs. Clark comes out of the Philadelphia zone, takes a long shot off the backboard. Jockerman cuts it off to the side with Nolet coming in. Clark backhands it around behind the goal. Clark, good pass out to Gilbert. Gilbert ahead intended for Rattel. Clark intercepted. He takes a hit from Gilbert. The puck comes to Barber. Check from behind by Rattel. Gilbert, backhand pass intended for Hatfield, too far. Joe Watson to Nolet. Nolet, number 17, is passed, broken up by Rattel. 9:34, regulation time remaining. Rattel, bumped by Joe Watson. Loose puck taken by Parks. Stick handles away from Clark. To Rattel. Rattel to Gilbert. Back to Rattel, but broken up by Dupont. Barber trying to break away. Rolf is there ahead of him. Dale Rolf in the Ranger zone. Rolf, number 5, over their line. Has Rattel with him. Passes to Rattel. Rattel back to the blue line. Park to Fairburn. Fairburn gets it off the leg. Fairburn shoots a tip-in try by Vickers over the glass. And up into the souvenir country. 9:03 to go. To Harris. Ron Harris shoots it right at Dupont. Gets it again off the skate of Kachuk offside. Kachuk, Vickers, Fairburn against McLeish, Lonsbury, Dornhofer. The goal scorers in the game, Fairburn for New York, McLeish for Philadelphia on a power play in the first period. Kindrychuk unassisted, Dornhofer from McLeish for Philadelphia in the second period, made it 3-1. Vickers for New York, Dornhofer his second goal for Philadelphia here in the third period. Flyers control this draw, Dupont to McLeish. McLeish is checked by Nielsen. Nielsen backhands it in. Rangers had tremendous pressure that led to that second goal of theirs, but the Flyers have bounced back with their goal, and the play has been about even since then. Kachuk inside the line. Checked by McLeish and Dupont. Puck comes out to center ice. Nielsen knocks it away from McLeish, but Dornhofer follows on. Here's McLeish. McLeish turns away from Harris. McLeish in the slot off the skate of Lonsbury. Lounsbury. Lounsbury back of the net. Oh, he hit the post as he tried to tuck it in. He bounced it off the post. Lounsbury, good try. Harris and Dornhofer collide in the corner. Jockelman out of the goal. Around the boards of Vickers. Vickers trying to get it to Kachuk. Vickers tries again. Kachuk has it. Kachuk has Fairburn with him. Two on two. Vickers comes up. Three on two. Pass to Vickers. Vickers with Fairburn. DuPont is back. Vickers drop pass for Park. Park into the slot. Slap shot blocked by Gary Dornhofer. Fairburn takes it away from Lounsbury. He's checked by DuPont. DuPont bangs it out to center ice. Dale Rolfe off the boards for Fairburn. Fairburn, two Flyers converge on him. He hands it right to Dornhofer of Philadelphia. McLeish breaks out. Fairburn checking him. McLeish backhands it in. A bounce shot. And Jockelman cuts it off. Makes a good move away from Bill Flett. Teams changing on the move. Dale Rolfe ahead intended for Stemkowski. Blocked by Selesky. Tripping penalty coming up to Selesky. Rangers control. They can get the goalie out here. Irvin swings away, but it's touched by Flett. And the whistle blows as Philadelphia gets possession. A penalty to Don Selesky. Out to kill off the penalties, as you might expect. And he's battling with Rattel. He gets it over the Ranger line. Clark, Barber, Jim Watson, and Van Imp. Ranger power play. Park and Russo on the blue line. Rattel, Hadfield, and Gilbert up front. Brad Park. Slowly over the line. To Gilbert. Gilbert to Russo. Russo, a drive, deflected. And Rattel shot it right through the crease. He had the chance to miss the net. Rattel tried to just steer that in, and he shot it right behind the goalie through the crease. Gilbert centering try, blocked by Clark. Clark comes out of there. Slowly gets around Russo, but the puck went all the way to Jockelman, and it clears it out quickly to Hadfield. Back for Park. Park over to Russo. Bobby Russo to Park. 1:15 left in the penalty. Park brings it up. Park whirling at the blue line, looking for the open man. Park looking for the open man. Over to Russo. Russo to Hadfield, who steers it in front for Gilbert, but Perrant dives out and caught that puck to make sure that Gilbert had no chance to make a play.
Rattel had Perrant beat, put the puck right across the net behind him, and that, of course, would have made it 4-3. And this is the 20th power play advantage for the Rangers without scoring a goal. Here's the deflection by Rattel. As you see, Perrant looks in the net, but Rattel put it right across the net into the corner.
59 seconds left in Selesky's tripping penalty. 6:28 remaining in the third period. Philadelphia leading 4-2. The winner meets Boston starting Tuesday night in the Stanley Cup Championship Finals. We'll have the third game of that series next Sunday afternoon, 4 p.m. Eastern Time here on NBC. You'll also see the final round of Showdown. Jim Tappan of the Blackhawks against Jill Villemure of the New York Rangers. Clark against Stemkowski on this faceoff to the right of Bernie Perrant. Stemkowski, Fairburn, Vickers, Park. Kachuk got on the point, now replacing Russo there. Park controls to Joe Watson, who blasts it around the boards. Dornhofer has it, gets it over the blue line. Stopped by Park, checked by Fairburn now. Dornhofer still battling and got it down to the New York line. Stemkowski back for it, 45 seconds remaining in the penalty. Beats Stemkowski to Kachuk. Kachuk checked by Lounsbury, and it's knocked over the blue line. Lounsbury plays an awful lot of hockey for this team. Ed Sherrow, his coach, said he should have been the MVP winner of the Hart Trophy this year. Fairburn stopped at the blue line as he lost control. Lounsbury whacks it down the ice. The Flyers without Bob Kelly, out with a bad knee. Bill Clement also out with a bad knee. Barry Ashby with the eye injury. Rangers have everybody there, but several of them playing hurt. Long pass for Vickers, too far. Perrant clears it off the glass. Kachuk knocks it to the corner. 7 seconds left in the penalty. Watson checks Vickers. Here's Kachuk again. Kachuk for Stemkowski. Stemkowski to Sealing at the blue line. Sealing, a low drive. Loose in front. Score! Pete Stemkowski from Rod Sealing. And it's 4-3. For the rest of this period, he won't have much trouble. Irvin trying to stick handle around Kindrichuk. Puck knocked out to Bill Flett. Coming out by himself. Now looks for some help. Nielsen and Harris were waiting for him back there. The puck jumped over Jockelman's stick. Ron Harris in the corner. Harris for Stemkowski. Couldn't handle a pass. Flett takes a good hit from Harris. They both go down. Kindrichuk checked by Nielsen. Stemkowski comes in to go for the puck, and Flett follows him in there, and they'll have a faceoff in Ranger territory. And you would think the younger Philadelphia club would be stronger in the third period, but so far in the series, the Rangers have outscored the Flyers in the third periods of each game. Park out to Dale Rolfe. Very crisp intercept, shoots it back in. 4-17. Remaining in the third period, the Flyers lead by a goal. Rolf brings it around the boards. It comes all the way to Watson. Jim Watson waits for people to get onside and shoots it in. Dale Rolf for Hatfield. Rattel, Hatfield, and Gilbert. Hatfield takes a good stiff check from Van Imp, or Rattel, pardon me, and then Hatfield upset Van Imp. The puck underneath him for a face. Kachuk controls to Brad Park. To Kachuk. Kachuk is checked by DuPont. Dale Rolf brings it up to Kachuk. Kachuk, the low drive, stick save, steer to the corner, rebound to Vickers. Vickers for Kachuk, can't get a shot out of the way, and it's brought out by McLeish. Rick McLeish has Dornhofer with him, Lonsbury trailing. Rick McLeish trying to get around Parker, shot at the side of the goal, rebound Lonsbury, save Jokinen, and a sliding save on Lonsbury. Vickers passed way too far for Fairburn, goes deep into the fire zone. Touched there by DuPont, icing call. For the goal on the faceoff, Jockman made the stop. Harris back of the goal. Ted Irvin and Barber battle over there for it. The puck comes loose. Crisp and Nielsen. Nielsen kicked it. Crisp is kicking at it. It's still loose. Barber comes up. A shot right on. And Jockman made the save there, and he was screened. Jockman goes out of the net with the puck. Gives it to Nielsen. Nielsen out of his own zone. 3:05 to go. Ron Harris ahead, intended for McGregor. Too far. DuPont to Clark. Clark looks for somebody to pass to, can't find him, and dumps it in. Irvin, back of his own goal, spins away but lost it to Barber momentarily, slammed it away, Barber has it again. Harris gives him a good body check. Clark, passing to Barber, well covered by Harris. Barber throws it out in front, and Stemkowski intercepts. Intended for McGregor, Chris stops it, Clark fires it in, the Flyers keep the puck in range of territory. 2:37 to go, 4-3, the Flyers lead. Have not quit at any stage of this series. Demkowski, a long shot wide. Selesky off the board. Selesky, met by McGregor. Shoots it, comes off with a bad bounce. Jim Watson battling, checked by Demkowski. Joe Watson has it. Around the board, Dale Rolf keeps it in. Back to the near board corner. Jim Watson with it there. Trying to get it out. Park trying to keep it in. A bouncing puck comes out to center ice. Irvin gives it to Rolf. 2:05 to go. Rolf to Park. Park with the crowd going wild here at the Spectrum. Shoots it into the corner. Offside is called at the Philadelphia blue line. Exactly 2 minutes remaining in regulation time. The Flyers leading 4-3, and this crowd is going slowly hysterical here. I was about to say insane, but they might not like that.
We're getting close to another record, Tim. In the Toronto series, Toronto and Boston, 48
against Rattel. Rattel gets it to Gilbert. Fakes a shot. Gets through and offside is called again at the Ranger line. And a close call there as Rattel had a break in on the Flyer goal, but offside called it back. Park and Rolf and Emil Francis going with his veterans out there. The gag line, the goal of game line that had an offseason this year. To put it mildly, for the New York Rangers, Rod Gilbert had himself a great campaign, but Rattel and Hatfield less than their usually steady selves over the course of the regular season. But they're the old pros out there. They've been here before, and he's going with them in this circumstance. Park shoots it in. Van Imp. Van Imp up the boards to Selesky. Selesky knocks it out over the blue line, hit the linesman, D'Amico, but Gilbert still back at his own blue line, gets it to Rolf. 1:38 to go. Rolf is upset by Kindrachuk. The puck over the Flyer line. Crowd breathes a sigh of relief that no penalty was called. Jim Watson out to Kindrachuk. Park gambling up there. Hope check on him by Hatfield. Still has the puck. It gets to Selesky. 1:23 left. He shoots it in. Jokinen feeding it up the left side. Too hard for Hatfield. Van Imp hustles to keep it in. 1:13 left. Rolf. Dale Rolf turned back by Bobby Clark. Stick hand and hit it to Park. 1:06. That goalie will be coming out. Here he comes. Park brings it over the line. Six Ranger attackers. A pass to Rattel. Too well covered. Lonsbury shoots it out to the blue line. Selesky shoots it down the ice. He goes out of wide of the empty goal. Selesky tries from his own blue line. In front. They've called too many men on the ice against the New York Rangers. That's why the faceoff's in there. Evidently, Jokinen did not get off the ice before the Rangers got the extra man on. And Vic Hatfield, the Ranger captain, arguing vociferously with referee Art Stoll. John D'Amico made the call. I saw him make the motion. but I didn't know what he was motioning about, but he was looking at the Ranger bench down here below us, and he ruled that the Rangers had too many men on the ice. It must have occurred during the attempt to get Jockelman out of the goal off the ice to get the extra attacker on.
And as we mentioned about D'Amico and Pavlich, the great linesmen that they are, you can rest assured that John D'Amico, in this very tight situation, for sure there were too many men on the ice. There wouldn't be any doubt about it at all.
He was looking directly at the Ranger bench when he made the call. He was directly in front of our microphone position here. And while we could not see, because the crowd stood below us, we could not see whether or not the penalty should have been called. He was looking directly at it. He did not even watch Selesky's shot. The shot against Kachuk. Kachuk controls this one to Park. Park blasts it around the boards, can't get it out. Dornhofer keeps it in. Park checked by Lonsberry. Lonsberry in the corner, using up some time, trying to get it back, still has it in the corner. Park bumps him, 37 seconds to play in the third period. Dornhofer. Dornhofer whirling away from Park, back of the net. Dornhofer to Lonsberry, back of the goal. Lonsberry checked by Fairburn. Rolf and Bobby Clark battling. Go to the far boards, and Rolf has to settle for a faceoff. 16 seconds remain. Bobby Clark, Lonsberry, and Dornhofer doing their usual strong forechecking job. The Rangers, a man short, having difficulty getting out of there.
Philadelphia were trying to protect that two-goal lead at the start of this third period, and they just started to lay back, and now they're back into what their normal game is, forechecking.
1:25 remaining in that penalty, which doesn't mean a thing. There are only 16 seconds left. I shouldn't say it doesn't mean a thing. If the Rangers scored, it would continue into the overtime. But 16 seconds left in regulation time. Clark against Demkowski. Demkowski got it. It's taken by Park. Park trying to shoot it out and hit Clark, and Russo did the same thing. That Clark is just where the puck is. Jockelman took it to Russo. To Demkowski. The crowd counting down. 3 seconds left. Clark has the puck. The game is over. And the Philadelphia Flyers have defeated the New York Rangers 4-3 and have moved into the finals against the Boston Bruins. And we'll be back in just a moment. Other after the battle is over. A rough, tough series, but these men appreciating the efforts on both teams, and the Flyers advance, and there is an embrace by Terry Crisp with Ed Jockelman, the Ranger goaltender. An exciting, thrilling Stanley Cup hockey game. The Flyers winning it 4-3 to win the series 4-3. And Ted Lindsay, certainly great credit to Fred Chero and these expansion Flyers. The final score, Philadelphia 4, the New York Rangers 3, this afternoon's Stanley Cup playoff game has been brought to you by your Dodge dealer, who's right on target with 12 Dodge Dart models. NHL Stanley Cup action resumes next Sunday on NBC at 4 p.m. Eastern Time. Game 3 of the championship round between Boston and the Philadelphia Flyers. Tim Ryan for Ted Lindsay and Brian McFarland saying good afternoon from the Spectrum in Philadelphia. NBC Sports, number one in live coverage of major sports events all year round.